right, folks, welcome to Mercy Kill. This is episode 2, and here I have Mitch Flower Power with me, who will be playing SMB3 Mix, and not only a Mario 3 game. Everybody hold your breath. Oh my gosh, there's going to be Mega Man 3 played by Mitch as well, which up to 2 days ago, I didn't even know that Mitch had even played any of the Mega Man games, so oh my
That's goodness, right. That's
going to be awesome. So real quick, a few housekeeping things for GDQ. Mercy Kill is brought to you by viewers like you. If you'd like to support the stream as well as other programs on GDQ Hotfix, please consider subbing to the channel. If you have Amazon Prime, remember you have a Twitch Prime sub. Please consider using that if you have not already to sub to the channel and support it. Tomorrow at 7 p.m. Eastern, we'll be having Resident Evil 2 Remake on the first step. For more information on GDQ Hotfix shows, as well as how to submit your runs, go to gamesdonequick.com/hotfix. SGDQ 2020 Online will be going on August 16th through the 23rd. With the schedule released on July 13th, you can now go to gamesdonequick.com for more info on SGDQ. That being said, Mitch, welcome to Mercy Kill. We're so happy to have you here tonight.
Yeah, I'm happy to be here. This sounds like fun, and not doing a Mario game as well is kind of got me a little excited.
So I will tell you something. It will feel fun during these interviews, but when you're in that hot seat and you're going to be going against that timer of your choosing, which, by the way, 140 is going to be the first timer that Mitch will have to beat here with, I believe you had a 102.38
yep.
for your PB.
Yep.
So
you was a world record at one point. So let's see how I fare against it. Right.
Right. When did you PB last, Mitch?
The last PB in this game was, I think it was about 2 weeks after the GDQ where I raced this with Jabum and Gedeon.
That
was 2000, and so it was about close to 2 years ago was my last PB in this.
So
it was the last time I played it, too.
With this being on the SMB3 engine, how rusty at this game can you really be? When this was the first selection, way before any of this Mega Man 3 banter we had, I was thinking to myself, there's no way. And then if he PBs, people are going to think I'm a fraud for having the show because that's not rusty enough.
No way possible could I PB.
No.
So with it being on the Mario 3 engine, the first thing that's not going to screw me over is my control over one of the characters. Because you can choose, Toad, Luigi, or Mario. They all share the same physics and everything, but that's not going to mess me up. What's going to mess me up is, do I do a full big jump here? Oh my gosh, where is that Goomba there? I can't remember. What's the next? That's what's going to get me the most. So it's going to scare me into not using my P-Speed strategies because I'm going to forget what some of the next jumps are. But there are going to be some levels where I'll probably remember, so this is exciting. We'll see.
You say that, and then you're not going to miss a jump, and I'd be like, Mitch, this is the Rust show, okay? We're not expecting world record caliber tactics here, but the physics engine will be the same. That's why how rusty could this get?
Well, one thing I know that I'll be able to do is 1-1. The first level in this game is a copy of Super Mario Bros. 1 first level. So, I mean, I'm not going to forget what that level looks like. I don't think anyone can forget what Mario 1 looks like, so at least I know I won't mess up that level, or I say I won't.
So, when did you first learn the run for SMB3 Mix? How long has it been for you?
It was when the game actually first came out, around 2015 or 2016 was when I first played this. I beat it, and then there was a lot of glitches kind of found, a lot of bugs and problems, so then Southbird updated it, and then updated it again. And then I had to replay it to have a more verified run with the current version, which was in about 2016 or 17. And then some other people came along, like Jabum. Jabum was the first one who came along, and then he started beating my times and getting better. So he kind of pushed me to come back. So I've been a little dicey with this game. I played it when it first came out, played it again on the newest version, then kind of stopped for a while. Somebody beat my time, then I came back, and we swapped strats, and then now I currently don't really touch the game right now.
So on the subject of diciness, how many safety strats do you plan to use? Is there one in particular that you're even thinking about right now?
There is not. So one of the biggest things with this, the difference between, you know, other games and your primary games is that I don't have well-established backup strategies in this game because I didn't play it enough as, you know, Mario 3. Mario 3, I know all the backup strategies for everything. If anything goes wrong, I'll know what to do. But in games that aren't your primary game, like, I'm going to have to wing it. winging it.
Yeah, we've seen somebody in chat saying pipe strats and all that. Y'all laugh, but Mitch did glitch into a block right before this while we were setting up. So that kind of thing can happen here. And I told Mitch, you know, we saw last week in Mercy Kill, Kizaron's save corruption thing happened, and we had to make a decision on the spot as to what to do. I told Mitch, if you softlock trying to showboat, that is on you. That will count against your time, and we're going to hold him to that as the audience, all right? So, Mitch, don't do anything too silly, all right?
I won't. Actually, to back to one of your questions, there is a strategy in World 6 where you use your tail to fly over, it's like a, I don't know what that goop's called from Mario Sunshine, that purple stuff. It's like grape soda, you know, it's like a lava. I don't know what it is, but you normally fly over that pit, and I'm not going to do that. There's
You're
no way I'm
going to
do that. No way am I going to do that strategy. It's like a, you'll see it, it's kind of fun. Maybe I'll try it once if I'm feeling, you know.
I seem to remember someone a long time ago teaching me how to maintain P-Speed with this Mario 3 physics engine in general, and I remember you gave me a hard time over using the tail, so I may have to tease you during some of those segments where you rely on the tail a little bit more than you should. Just
everything
saying.
Everything comes around, you know, full circle, so I deserve it.
if really... it So, and I'll ask you this later as well. This is the same thing I have to ask for every single game. What inspired you to run the game in the first place? And was it a mistake to learn? A lot of people regret some of their speedrunning decisions, folks, because that's something that you have to reset and play over and over and over to get good at a game. Do you have any regret associated with this game at all?
Not with this game, but I understand the regret. When you get to a certain point when speedrunning games, you can't go back from it. And not this game, no. This game's really fun. It's a combination of Mario 1, 2, Super Mario Land, 6 Golden Coins, Super Mario Sunshine, and some other things. So it's just like all these Mario games thrown in the Mario 3 engine. This is like my dream. This is like everything I could have asked for. But it's still not as good as the original Mario 3, so that's why I didn't stay full with this game. But no regrets, no regrets.
Well, it looks like the crowd is getting restless here. You have a lot of fans here, and we'll get ready to start in a second, but Mitch, I would like you to introduce yourself really quickly, and what have you been doing on your stream the past few years?
Mitch Flower Power. The last few years have just been, I ended last year with doing some, like, hard games. I ended up beating Zelda 2, Castlevania, Ninja Turtles 1, and I think they're, Ninja Gaiden, that's right, without ever really playing them or beating them as a kid, so that was my first for me, and then I did January all Dark Souls. I beat Dark Souls 1, 2, and 3 in January. That was a lot of fun. Those games are incredible. And then ever since then, just Mario 3 grinds. I ended up getting one of the fastest warpless non-early hammer times, which is a really, really incredible run. I beat myself by over 10 seconds, and I beat the previous one by over 7 seconds. So yeah, that's about it. Just grinding away.
That's awesome. And I can't say that I've seen too many people as dedicated to one game as you are to Super Mario Bros. 3. And we will see that reflected because of the physics engine, if anything, in this. Mitch, are you ready to go?
Yeah, I'm ready to go, sure.
All right, let's do the thing then. Let's do the thing then. Now, I am going to heckle you a little bit. This is my job during this. I'm supposed to heckle you on behalf of myself and the audience here. So everybody's going to hold
your questions, right? People are going to have questions?
Yep, people are more than willing to ask questions. I'll be able to see them and relay to Mitch as best as I can.
Keep them coming.
All right, let me make sure I get the green light here. All right, looks like everything is good and ready to go. I am going to count you down as long as you are ready.
Yeah, I'm ready. I'm paying attention, I swear.
Mitch has given the dot ready. Here we go. In 3, 2, 1... Go! Good luck and have fun, Mitch.
Who should I pick? We gotta go for Toad.
Yeah, I got it.
We can't not be Toad in a game like this. So, worst World 1 music, but it is the start, so it's not so bad. And it's actually not faster right now in the speedrun to actually take this pipe, but we're gonna go Mario 1 style, aren't we? Yeah.
Oh, why not?
Try and go for the clip here. Not even close. We'll try one more time. Okay. We tried.
Your PB picked Mario, by the way, Mitch. Any reason for that?
What was I thinking? Picking Mario.
You're making fun of past Mitch when you know past Mitch is going to have a huge edge on you come later on.
He's got such an advantage on me picking Mario. That's cosmic brain strats. I don't know how I thought that. I did PB once or twice with Toad, so it's not so bad. You gotta, like, change it. I never really picked Luigi. Jabum was always super Luigi. He was like, Luigi all the time, Mitch. I couldn't go with it.
I was going to ask if you, Gadion, and or Jabum just had some kind of superstition around what kind of character you picked in this game.
Okay, we didn't, but for some reason, Gadion always picked Mario, I always picked Toad, and Jabum always picked Luigi.
Oh, that's funny.
Right? I gotta slow down. See, the strats I was talking about, I can't remember them. So, we're gonna have to... What's this? Okay, coin block. Okay, I think I'm good here. Yeah, we're good. Alright.
Yes, yeah. So what's going on right now for everybody coming in, it starts with SMB3 Mix. I wanted to have Mitch play something a little more what Mitch is known for. This is a mod of Mario 3 done by Southbird. This is SMB3 Mix. After this, we will have a break, and then there will be Mega Man 3 action. And Mitch hasn't touched that game in over 4 years, so...
Very long time.
A very long time ago. Much. And we'll talk about this during the interview a little bit more. Mitch doesn't even have a video for that PB. This predated speedrun.com, so
no video, no proof. I've been living a lie. I never truly ran it.
I don't know if people are going to believe you.
Okay, so a couple things before you get into any questions and stuff. For anyone who doesn't know how this game works, these little circle mushrooms here, these are checkpoints right there, and they also give you power-ups. Instead of having the end cards at the end of the level, for anyone who doesn't know how this game works, these coins right here, you collect 3 of them in each level. You collect all of them in the entire game for every level, and you'll unlock certain things. So this is not a small game. I thought I'd just let you guys know. And being as this is Mario 1 for World 1, you know, we're doing Bowser. Bowser's the boss. World 2 is Super Mario Bros. 2, so get ready. That's why this game was really good. That's why I got into it, because it just really comboed all the games together. Whee! Oh, wait. Hold on. We gotta go for the Toad merge here. We have to be one with the Toads. Ah, I was almost. with the Toads.
Let me ask you this. Why 140? Did you just want to give yourself an extra half hour or so, give or take?
Yeah, I think half an hour is a pretty good estimate for me. If I don't skip auto-scrollers, if I die, if I make mistakes. The any percent itself is, like, pretty short, so it's not, like, too crazy. Also, just a reminder, there's ghost houses from Super Mario World, so that's pretty cool. Yoshi is in this game. Oh, we got it! Staircase glitch. Right on. So normally you'd have to go through, like, a doorway and then circle back, but not me.
Mitch, have you been practicing?
I swear to God, no. I swear I haven't.
No, that was a heck of a clip. I don't know what everyone's going to say about that, right?
I just remember resetting on that clip a lot, so I'm very, like, either I get it or I don't. I feel like no matter how much I practice. And again, this is all, like, Mario 1 levels, so very easy to remember, but I can still make mistakes. Like, this level is still Mario 1. Yeah, make... lose there. A lot of turn backs coming from me, but it's actually pretty fun. I really enjoy what you have going on here, Sky. This is really, really cool. Thank you very much.
Oh, no problem. I'm just holding you accountable on behalf of the people, okay? We're seeing some clips right now, and I don't know if someone super rusty would know how to do that. We'll see. We'll see this more reflected in the Mega Man game, and I'll tell y'all the estimate for that. I'm gonna keep y'all kind of holding on for that one. The estimate on Mega Man 3 is not generous, in my opinion. I think if anything's gonna get Mercy Kill tonight, it will be the Mega Man 3, because...
Hey, hold on. This is only World 1. We're only a couple levels in. You have to remember, as speedrunners, this is the world I played the most. So I should remember it the most. We'll see. Toad merch. There we go.
So
and I swear I didn't practice. I promise you. There's no... Okay, this level's a perfect example. There's no way I'm going for P-speed strategies in this level.
No.
So if you watch the video below, you'll see what I did in this level, and it's just, there's no way I'm going for this.
So for those of you who are new to Mercy Kill, I have to remember, this is only episode 2. The premise of this show is, it is the player against the timer, in this case the speedrunner against the timer. And once that timer lapses, if the runner is not finished with the game, that's it. They get cut off. This is not a, let's do the participation trophy approach and have them finish the run. No, this is Mercy Kill. We do not show any kind of compassion when it comes to finishing within that estimate. We are very strict with that timer. The one That's exception, right. again, being when Kizaron Save Corruption faltered, you know, it was episode one, I decided to be a little nicer, but I'm trying to set some better parameters for things like that. That's why I told Mitch about the soft lock thing.
Now I'm really nervous for Mega Man 3. Okay, I have a Fire Flower, so I'm going to use this because there is a clip that I can do. Pretty standard, just like Mario 3 clip stuff. And this is the last level in Mario 1, so I know this level pretty well.
So
right,
we have
all know the wall jump comes up right here and stuff. Yeah. Okay, go ahead, Sky.
We have a question from the chat. Is Mitch arguing that he is more likely to get Mercy killed on this one? I want to know the answer to that one, too.
No.
Okay, what was the question, sorry?
I'm sorry. That was really appropriate, Kevin. No.
I know. I went in the pipe. I didn't even mean to. Dang it. So see stuff like this? A big time loss compared. I don't even know what this area looks like, right? Because, like, in the actual speedrun, if we don't get that clip or something, it's like a reset. All right. Okay.
Mitch opting to take the scenic route when he's racing the timer. I don't know if I would recommend that if you're a contestant on this show.
I tried the clip. I accidentally went the pipe. It's my fault. I'm to blame.
So the question was, do you think this run is likely to get Mercy killed? Because it seemed like you were arguing against me that it could.
It totally could, yeah. It totally could. It's very possible. There's lots of auto-scrollers. There's huge time-save strategies in this game because some levels are really long. And like I'd mentioned, that tail strategy in World 6 that I wasn't going to do because it's very precise, that's like a 3-minute time loss just right there. So it's very possible. And like here, yeah, I don't even...
Uh-oh. Yeah, I think what Mitch is saying is that a lot of people underestimate how easy it is to lose time on these games. You know, these little mistakes, the stop and P-speed, they all add up over time. So I totally...
Yeah, I mean, I'm only in World 2-1. I have to be at least a minute or two behind by now.
Well, let's see what Past Mitch is doing here in the corner. I'll see if I can tell where it is.
It's probably like halfway through World 2 already. I can't imagine.
Yeah, it looks like they're past the fortress in 2 already, if I saw that properly.
Alright, so this level is another one that... Yeah, this level is always a struggle in the speedruns, because it's like... From Mario 2, you know, you got the flying things and the ice. I think it's World 4 this level's from in Mario 2. And, like, I don't even know where the jumps are. Like, over there's a coin and stuff. Oh, shoot, that's important. How many times do you think people say that in, like, speedrunning? Oh, that's important. I feel like every mistake should have that at the end of it. Oh, well, there goes my chance. PB, well, PB bus to earn run.
As you know, part of the GDQ experience, hotfix and marathons, is that's never happened before. That's always a very famous saying that happens here. So we'll see if we get one of those today.
So I tried to remember this section here, but I didn't remember it quite. Is there a power up there? Nope. Okay, but I think I'm safe here. Yeah, okay. In Mario 3, you can't actually jump up vines, but in this game you can, so it's very nice. Flagpole glitch, did you guys see that? I just got the flagpole glitch. I didn't actually get it, but I always brag that I do. I don't even think it's possible in this game. Alright, here we go. Okay, so what do I do in this level? Oh, this level's pretty fun, because you get to, like, you get to climb. We all know this level from Mario 2. Oh my gosh, what happened? Yeah, see, with the jumping up vines, this makes this level really fun with the Mario 3 mechanics.
Yeah.
How you doing over there, Sky? You getting nervous? You think you're gonna mercy kill me?
No, I mean, I won't be able to tell. You gave a 140 estimate. I still think if it's gonna happen, my bets are on the Mega Man 3 run getting mercy killed, but we'll see. I mean, I would like to see you at least save one of these two runs tonight. That is the hope, at least. Because now we're currently 1-0 right now. Kizaron started us all off on the right foot with mercy kill. Certainly nice to keep it in the W column, but I, you know, you have to take a look at the chat. They like a good show. They want it to be close, you know? It's no fun if it isn't close.
We got him, okay.
Whee! Nice fight!
Right. Yeah, wait until we get to, like, World 6 and 7, the more complicated. Ooh, I gotta try and go for the clip here. Big time saves. Big time saves. What? Does anyone remember my GDQ run here? I spent like a minute and a half here. Oh, I remember that.
Uh-oh. This is Mitch's risk here.
Ah, we got it. Okay, but I still have to get a 4-frame wall jump out here. Very scary. Oh, if I didn't get that jump, I would have died. See, and those are the things I can't account for in the mercy kill, pretty much. Scary. That's pretty risky.
That took you a few tries to get in the wall, too. That looked like tough spot.
Yep, and I have to fight this extra guy, and apparently the game decides to run at like 13 frames per second there. There's a couple sections in this game where there's just way too many enemies. Seth Bird did a great job, but then sometimes he was very, very precise with how the levels were in the original games. And the engine was kind of... Uh-oh, hold on. Oh, that's so scary because you're off screen.
So, Mitch, let's say you didn't get that clip through the wall. How long is that level?
I think it would have cost me an additional 20 or 30 seconds.
Okay.
Maybe even 40. Had to get that speed strat there. I love the music, too. Really good music in this game. Uh-oh. I totally forgot that was there. Uh-oh.
Yeah, for those of you wondering, we don't do these runs in advance. This is not pre-recorded. The runner is put on the spot in front of an audience to complete a run within an estimate of their choosing, as long as it's not too generous. If they err on the side of not being too generous, I won't stop them. But if they, you know, if Mitch were to make the estimate 3 hours, I'd be like, that's got to come down a little bit. Otherwise,
nice try, Mitch. Yeah, nice try, buddy. So how far behind do you think I am?
Let's see. You are currently in Mitch's PB, in the wall after a boss. It looks like the end of World 2.
Love that. That's such a speedrunning thing to say. You are in a wall fighting a boss.
That's so
speedrunner-esque. I love it.
It's very you.
You would never hear anything like that. Oh, wait, what? There's a wall there? Well, and there goes more speedrunning lingo. There's a wall there. Didn't know that. Oh, no. So losing Fireflower there is a very big time loss here because I have to wait now for each single one of these. But luckily... Nice. Oh, yeah. Come on, move your butts. So by not killing them, they now spawn on the platform.
We don't want to see that happen. That's rough.
All right. Still, ooh, watch out for that. Still a lot of fun, though. So now that opens up the door, the little switch. Nice. We in there.
Yeah, this room actually looks pretty rough. This is from 3-3 in Mario 2.
That's right. Right? You have, like, jump debates here, right? Where, because you can't see above, and then you jump, and then those spinny guys are there. Right, every time you jump. Right there's one. See that? Right there. Okay. Look at how long this is. Big room. I think there's like a trick to this boss, but I can't remember it. It's something to do with... Got him. And then there's one more. I think... Do I throw it over here? I think so. Go! Yeah, nice. See you later, Mauser. Nice, not bad.
Doing pretty well so far. Just remember, again, I know your PB got stuck in the wall at the end of this because you like to do that for fun. Remember what happens if you actually get softlocked somewhere. That's all I'm saying, just bear warning.
I do not want to get softlocked.
No.
That's how you lose. It's that. Well, mercy killed. It was like, well, I could restart, but that would be like a 20-minute time. Okay. So we got these levels. Okay, pretty good. And then, yeah, this. So I have to be close to like 4 minutes behind by now, right?
Someone in chat had said 3:25 behind it. It looked like right now.
that so close.
Okay, so your World 2 finish was a 12:59, it looks like. We'll see what time it is when you complete this.
Okay.
That'll be how much you're actually behind. So 12:59 was your PB at the end of 2 here. Dang, Wart looks like a really difficult boss in this game.
Yeah, he could be really hard too, and sometimes the Shy Guys go really close to him. It's very scary to pick him up. Okay. I had to go for it.
No, Mitch, no. No, I cannot. I cannot support unnecessary wall clips, Mitch. All right, so it looked like a 16:26 would have been your split there, and 12:59 was your PB. So do the math, and that's how far off you are from your PB.
Yeah, I'm not math and time right now. Mm-hmm. I got more important things, like unintentional wall clips.
No,
just
Mitch.
Nobody tell Sky about it.
I get so nervous when you do that. Do not do that.
It's possible if you get stuck. Oh, can I get this one though? No, not even close. I wasn't even close. There is a time save there. If I clip into that, I'll go straight into the water instead of having to do these pipe transitions.
Whee!
Shout out to Darbyan right now. Woo! 6 golden coins.
Yeah, he's been putting some serious work into that game.
Like, this is like the impossible power up. I'm lucky I still got. Look, you can't even get up there. Okay, now I have reserved P-Speed, so I should be able to P-Speed right to the end. Yeah, there we go. I gotta watch out for these guys. Okay, I got a pretty good pattern.
Nice.
Right on. All right. Level 2 with the... Oh, what do I do here again? Oh my gosh, look at the frame rate. I think I can... Yeah, there's an auto-scroller skip here after I do 4 FPS. Okay, right up here, I think. Yep. Not intended by the dev, I don't think. Is it block number 2? Where is it? There it is.
There you go. You have your fancy Mario Land 2 power up now.
Yeah, there we go.
Oh, nice. Nice skip there.
So there's a skip there that skips an auto scroller, but I couldn't remember. Ooh, that was close. I couldn't remember exactly where I got this power up from. I was unsure if it was in the blocks up there, but it was, thankfully.
I assume
speed strat, it's just like damage boost through it.
I assume that was a hole next to you at the end, where if you would have missed that, no dice.
No dice, that's right, that was very close. I think I'm doing pretty good right now with some of my on-the-fly movements with like trying to remember and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So there is... this suit, yeah, so hopefully I don't mess this up. It's very possible. I think I want to drop there, and then right here, 1, 2, and then straight. Yeah, and I think if I hit the flagpole right now, I do a weird walk-off. Yeah! Why am I in the air? I'm not even on the ground.
That's great.
Yeah, the water in this level is kind of weird. So the interesting thing with this is that you can't actually die in this Hammer Brother battle. It just restarts if you fall, so it's kind of cool.
You don't even lose your power-up if you fall there?
I don't think so, no. Oh, there's a clip here. No. Come on, baby. Come on.
Mitch?
It's not. This one's a real one, I promise. This
okay.
One...
All right, yeah, I'll take your word for it. All right. I was able to see the other side of the wall after a little while, so.
There's also another one.
Ooh, Black Snake. Oh, you didn't tell me about that!
I almost forgot about that one, but I did it. I almost ran out of time, too. Double clip. So that was something new that was actually discovered not too long after like the 2018 burst of this of the interest in this game, so it's pretty cool. It's dark. I can't see. Where
can't
do I
see
go?
Anything? I see things.
I think just that, yeah. Go ahead, Mr. Boo Ghost. Oh, did I get a quick one? No! Dang you, out of bounds walls.
You would know all about those, wouldn't you?
I still didn't hit him. Come on, buddy. Okay, there we go. First hit. I was like, easy 20 seconds lost right there. Oh, can I get this one? Yeah.
Yeah, I'm with you on this one, Richard. I feel like Mitch is remembering more than he should, too. I'm right there with you. Good thing we have another game. See, this is why I asked if there was anything else. Because
I swear. I swear.
I don't think myself or chat believes you right now.
Look, I swear I'm trying. I'm trying. See what happens when this gets out of control?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, okay. See, the cycles are so off right now, I can't,
This
I can't
is tough.
Do anything. I have no idea what damaged me right there. Okay, I should be good here, okay. Thank goodness.
Nice.
See, there's, don't worry guys, I got you. There's lots of stuff.
Well, this is what I was asking for in the pre-interview of this is, Mitch, how rusty can a game with Mario 3 physics actually get for you? It's kind of rusty, but I don't know, Mitch is doing a lot of swag here still, if I'm being honest. We'll see.
Yeah, it's just because I know certain levels where I can do P-speed strategies, but I'm losing time on, like, I've lost time on every single level.
Mm-hmm.
So, in my mind, I'm very rusty. Yeah, like, every level I've done so far, I've lost time on compared to my PB. Okay. So we got another swim level.
No, I can definitely tell. You know, I tease, but some of your jumps have looked a little sketchy, so I understand where some of that uncertainty is coming from.
So as long as I don't lose this... The ice suit kind of works just like the frog suit, but you don't get the movement stun. Like, you know how the frog suit, when you land on the ground, it kind of like, you kind of like goes slow and stop? Oh, well.
Aww. Letting you focus as you get through this. This probably is not pleasant without the penguin suit.
It is not. It is not. The music doesn't help too, it's all scary.
It's all spoopy.
There we go.
I like the gradual movement of that penguin suit.
Right? It's really comfy. Okay, what is this? No, we don't want that. I'll try and go for a glitch here. Like an auto kill. Nice, that was pretty cool.
Oh, nice.
So I froze the bullet right there, and then I kicked the bullet, because with the ice suit, you can freeze objects and kick them. So what it is, I froze the bullet and I kicked it in the air, and when it hit the Bowser Jr., every frame did a tick of damage, so it just like instantly gets him. So what are we at? What are we at in time now?
Well, let's see. That was about 24.0x, somewhere in there, like right over 24. And currently, right now, you are swimming through what looks like a water level with the hang on. I was trying to see if I could find your actual time for that, but if you remember the water room in Mario World, you know, the one where you swim
I
up
do,
and
yeah,
like
there's like spikes and music notes and stuff in this version, yeah.
That was the room you were in when you cleared the level, if that provides any kind of perspective to you.
Yeah, it's like 4 or 5 levels behind.
513 behind, thank you, chat, appreciate that. Thank you.
So we're almost at 110 right now.
Mm-hmm.
You can do shell jumps with Yoshi, which is pretty cool. Oh, come on, Yoshi. Stay with me, bud.
Yoshi does not want to work with you right now.
No, I'm doing really... Like, what was that?
What?
Okay, yeah, right? Okay, so I think a lot of you will remember this section from Super Mario World. This little section right here. Can't you do a glitch in Super Mario World?
Yeah, you're not getting wings here, Mitch. I don't think that's possible. This is the first part of... Sorry, the shell went through the ground and I just couldn't...
I know, everything's... When it's not a fine-tuned speedrun, everything's like all over the place.
That was a Vanilla Dome 1, though, or at least a copy of Vanilla Dome 1, most famously known for wings in the Super Mario World speedrun. No, I actually don't think Mitch can duplicate blocks in this one. No.
No, you can definitely not duplicate. Okay, come on. So, much like the things that I was talking about earlier, losing Penguin Suit here is over a minute and a half lost for sure. And this is some of the things that I was talking about with big time losses here. There's so many certain things that you need to, like, yeah, big time saves for, like, keeping power-ups and stuff. This is a scary one right here. Does anyone know what level this is from Super Mario World?
This is the one
with the big secret, isn't it? Somewhere?
Is this Forest? Forest 2? I'm trying to think now.
Yeah, this is one of those levels where if you lose your penguin suit before you get to this level in this world, it's like world records almost impossible. So it's like one of those strats.
Yeah, that was Forest 2. See, I miss Forest 2 most of the time because you're supposed to clip with a Yoshi and swim underneath, so I don't get to see a lot of the layout of Forest 2 anymore.
Again, with the speedrun, of course, right? Like, of course it's a level where you glitch into a wall. Like, that's so speedrunning. Alright, here it is, Sky. We got
all
it.
Alright. This is,
we got the leaf.
This is Castle 4, by the way, for anyone wondering. However, this is kind of odd, because in Castle 4 in Super Mario World, you're going from right to left, and here you're going from left to right, so there's that little bit of a difference there.
Go, go, go! No! Okay.
Oh my goodness. How did you not die there?
I did not get squished. I made it. That was close. So now I have to wait for the pipe, but also get the checkpoint. A lot of cycles and sequence breaks in the speedrun as well. I knew there was a power up here somewhere. Oh wow, that was cool. Oh my gosh.
This is another feature you don't get to see on the NES. These are the fences that
That's right.
you don't get to see till Super Mario World. And it's funny because this looks like another... this does look like part of the mod. This looks like one of the game's off-brand for a little while. With the kind of squished Reznors and the kind of odd-looking fence.
Right? They look so silly. Okay.
That's what happens when you try to put Reznor on a NES.
Everyone knows this level. I mean, right? No matter how rusty I am, you gotta imagine that, you know, anyone running a level like this, you're not going slow. No. Yoshi, come back! I mean, maybe my frame rate is going... What? That went right through him! Oh my gosh. Okay, so as long as I don't lose this, I can do another cool little trick here. Oh, come on, bud. Oh wait, I think you have to be small Mario. Crap. Alright, I'm out. I'm out of there.
Well, this looked like Vanilla Secret 2 until you went into the pipe. Now I don't know what this is.
This was probably like South Bird. He's like, nah, I can't think of anything else. So he just had like a little maze. Alright.
Nice.
I haven't done any Hammer Brothers yet, and I've got two fortresses. And I don't remember if this one's the one with the big jump. Ah, it is, okay. Oh no, I need that. I think there's a pipe right here too. Oh, swag strats.
Mitch and the swag strats. You're making me look bad, Mitch.
No way. We still have so much more left.
There is, there's a lot.
Game. Oh no.
That's a nice room still, even with the hit.
As long as I don't go through the platform, I should be alright. It's so laggy, right? You never know what's gonna happen here. I don't even know how it's stable. Like, how did the solid platforms even load with how laggy it is?
Yes, so for those of you just entering the channel, hello, this is Mercy Kill. This is episode 2. We currently have Mitch on playing SMB3 Mix, and later on, Mega Man 3, which I know everybody quite literally is waiting for after this. But the premise is we have well-known speedrunners here, and they run their rustiest game. And, well, this is allegedly rusty. I'm not going to advertise that quite as much, but with Mega Man 3, we'll definitely see more of that. So they take some of the rustiest speedruns, and they see if they can beat a timer of their choosing. Right now, Mitch's PB, for example, in SMB3 Mix is a 102, and we have 140 as our estimate here. We're not going to see quite that generous of a time gap with Mega Man 3. That's why I think it's going to be a little more visible there.
Yeah.
No, not Mega Man 3 DOS. No. Like, the actual Mega Man 3.
Not Mega Man 3 DOS. Anything but. What are we looking at? What are we looking at right now so far for time? Because I know losing that penguin suit and not having it for sections like these is really big time losses.
Well,
I'm actually kind of curious.
Your SMW World 4 finish on your PB, according to your splits, was a 25:41 that you were supposed to be done with this. Your current timer right now is a 31:43, and you're not past World 4 yet. So, losing a little bit of time in this one, for sure. This was a tough segment for you.
It was. That penguin suit was very important. Is there a star here? Where's the star? My star, it's gone. Oh god, this is like there should be a star here somewhere and I can't remember where it is. Now I'm really scared. Okay, we're safe. Power up. Oh, checkpoint.
Oh, I have an update for you. Past Mitch just finished World 5.
World 5?
Yeah, Past Mitch went fast.
Wait, I'm already done World 5 in the PB?
Yeah, 31:56 was the end of World 5. You're currently at a 32:30 right now and not finished with World 4 quite yet.
Yeah, I haven't even started World 5.
I told you, man.
Not keeping those power-ups are huge time losses. And I still have the 3-minute time loss in World 6 from... But you'll see it. You'll see it.
Yeah, Past Mitch is doing wonderfully. Past Mitch, everybody is applauding Past Mitch. You know, Past Mitch is just going all the fast, and we appreciate that.
Okay,
no, Mitch and I have known each other since,
very long time.
Geez, 5-6 years by this point. I think Mitch understands my gentle heckling and ribbing.
I love it. It makes this show is amazing. And is it possible for other people to, get in on this show? How does it work?
Absolutely. So the next couple of months, I may see if we can do a couple of additional ones too, because this show is very much in demand right now. Like, I cannot believe how much people love this show so far. We have so many shows booked for the next few months. So many shows. I mean, we're every other Tuesday right now, but you never know when there may be an extra one in there somewhere. So I would definitely follow GameStandQuick.com and go to the hotfix section to see what's going on with the programming behind Mercy Kill, because again, this show is very much in demand right now. Brand new, we're on episode 2, and people are just loving the premise behind this. It's fun to give the runner a tough time.
Oh my gosh, okay.
Everybody's
scared there for a sec.
Everybody's cheering on Past Mitch right now.
Past
you're fighting a boss, but in hidden, here comes Past Mitch, and everybody's like, yeah, Past Mitch, you can do it, go for it. All right, there's your World 4, 34:10. As a reminder to everyone just getting in, Mitch's World 4 was a 25:41, and currently Past Mitch is past World 5 at a 31:56. So, again, to put some perspective here, thank you very much, Chad. 8:28 behind right now is Mitch. Mitch left a 30 and change buffer, so we'll see. We're halfway through the game. It's still looking okay for Mitch's run to not get Mercy killed, but we'll see what happens. As Mitch says, it gets tougher as you get towards the end of the game, so anything is possible here.
That's right. Oh, I'll take that star. Yes! Anything for safety. I didn't even know that star was there. Safety, please. Good. How's everyone doing tonight? Is everyone having a good time? Hope you guys are having a fun time.
Everybody's having a great time from what I'm seeing in the chat.
Okay, I think I used one of the stars here. I think there is a weird soft lock in this level. I can't remember. Jabum would know if he's in chat. He'd probably mention it. But yeah, there's a weird soft lock in here. I've never done it in a run, but I know you can. It's really weird. Okay, this is another... I probably destroyed this level in the actual old Mitch, and I have no idea. Okay, oh. I hit the Genji.
That's a Mario 2 level.
Ninji. Like... What I call them a Genji.
Oh yeah, this is definitely Mario 2. We're in the sand and everything.
Oh, it was red, that's right. Whip! Right in there.
Nice.
Alright, look at that.
It's good.
I easily lost probably 15 seconds in just that level alone.
I like the sliding across the screen at the end.
Let's do it. Okay. There's a weird little clip here. Let's see if I can get it. Right? A quick one. Ah, oh, that would have been so cool. It's like a 2 second time save, right? It just clips me over here. Pretty interesting.
I like how Mitch barely braces me for the wall clips here. I just every single second he knows I'm gonna get nervous about that.
So many jumps. Okay, there's a coin down there that I don't need. And come on, dig faster, Toad. Uh-oh. Oh, I threw him! And then I started double digs. Alright. Oh, look. 10 frames a second. Oh! It came back!
What?
Okay. Please don't die. I should be safe here. It's possible.
I've heard Runner say I should be safe here before. Oh my gosh.
So, like... Because it's not an official game or anything, I can't imagine it had official testing, and like, it's very possible for me to like go right through the Sphinx there. That was risky, but I had no power-ups, there's nothing I could do. Okay, this was another level where I knew was going to be a pretty big time loss, because the cycles, right? It's mainly auto-scrollers, levels that have cycles, levels where you need power-ups. See, I can't go now. But in the speedrun with this level, it's like, go, go, go. Now, you know, it's like a minute lost. Oh my gosh, I thought I was dead. I thought this was the platform, okay.
I thought you got cameraed there for a second.
Yeah, that was a weird camera. Also, I actually just... Yeah. Okay. I think this is like a power-up section. I was supposed to keep going, that's right. So where does this take me then?
Well, you're the runner. You're supposed to tell us where it takes us.
I have no idea. I think this is like a secret exit. No, it's a coin. Is he still down? Okay. Alright, so unfortunately, that's not the exit we wanted.
No, the mercy kill does not happen when the PB ends. No, 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 no. I definitely allow extra time at the runner's choosing to do that. I don't think anyone would want to be on mercy kill if they ran a run, look, 4+ years ago when they were expected to beat their PB. No,
yeah,
no, 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 no.
Join our new brand new show, Mercy Kill. Beat your PB in one attempt. Yeah. Valid question, though. I mean, it makes sense.
Yeah,
so again,
yeah.
The cycle, right? You have to do perfect P-speed strategies at the start of this level if you want to beat this cycle here. So unfortunately, yeah, so I have to keep... Yeah, there we go.
No, I played through this game once for fun. The Mario speedrun I'm actually known for the most is Super Mario All-Stars All Games Warpless. I only played this one once for fun, but it is worth playing.
It is worth playing. This is a very fun game to play. Nice, we got it. Okay.
Alright.
So, again, like that, I also knew that it's possible I'd accidentally take the wrong secret exit. And then we got an auto-scroller.
Also, hang on.
Orb.
Orb. We got the orb.
There you go. Alright, we're getting some orbs in chat. Thanks, folks. I knew y'all wouldn't let me down there. Thank you.
So this sun level is a lot harder than the sun level in Mario 3, and I kind of forgot it was the sun level. So I didn't have a power-up, so I was a little nervous there at the start. Okay.
I always like orbs. They encourage audience participation, and that's always fun. Oh,
so
we even got the So Safe reference. Oh my, Mitch, you remember So Safe?
Come on! I was safe there. Wait, I still got the... Wow, that does not work like that in Mario 3. If you get small Mario and you grab a fire flower, you do not get... That's pretty cool. I didn't even know that.
You just noticed that now you were on the boss with the big boo and you kept going to small Toad and then you kept grabbing the suit and it kept powering you.
Yeah, see, I don't know. I thought that was because maybe boss... I wasn't thinking, Sky. I'm nervous. It's not my fault.
For someone in the hot seat, you're doing a very good job right now, right? Kizaran was, like, very, very, very nervous and tense most of last week. You're pretty chill so far.
That's right. Oh, gosh. No! Now I remember. Sometimes when you stomp on this little sphinx there, his fireball can keep doing damage to you, so you just, like, instantly die. That's what it is. That's pretty rough if that happens. So I should be able to skip sand, go on. Oh no, I'm gonna go for it anyways.
Some people in chat were saying earlier that I should have gotten Poo to heckle you as well during this.
Everyone's coming at the heckles right now.
Yeah. Pass Mitch just finished World 6 at 41:02.
Well, it's a good thing I didn't clip there. I don't know why I did that. That was one of the sky clips. You would have been very mad at me.
I'm glad I was focused on looking at what Passmitch was doing there for a second.
Thank goodness. Oh, I just got stomped. I just got stomped! There we go, nice. No way! Did I actually die? I did die!
Oh my god!
Ow! I was just like, you know, I was just farting around. You know, I was just floating, and then I had no idea there was a hole there. Okay.
Mitch, what did I tell you about farting around before this stream even started?
You specifically said no farting around. I remember.
I told you it was not a good idea to fart around because
no,
things
I
like
didn't
that
mean...
can happen.
It was funny, too, because I was just slowly floating. I thought I was being good. I was like, I dodged the spike. I was like, yeah, my flying's so awesome right now. But I ended up... Okay. Don't move, Mitch.
Yeah, don't move right now. That's very much advised.
Okay, here we go. Now I really gotta go fast here, because I took an extra exit, and... Dude, I swear, guys, I did not know you could die there. I thought there was another ledge you could stand on.
Chat had a really good time with that. That's all I'm going to say, Mitch.
Is there anyone in chat right now? Washed up Mario 3 runner. Can't play.
No. Nothing of that. Oh, don't give them ideas, though.
Oh, crap. I shouldn't have said it. Oh, darn. Sometimes those comments can be funny, but sometimes...
Yeah. It depends on where you are with the run.
Oh, I knew he was doing to do that, dude.
That's a hitbox right there.
Got fireballed right there. I didn't think he was actually going to go right away, but is it? Yeah, okay, I'm right at the boss. Very nice.
See, you just gave Chad ideas. See, you asked for that one, Mitch.
Nice, we got him. It's okay. I know the chat loves me, so I know it's just...
Oh, I know they
do. Oh, wow,
too.
I went right past them. Okay, there we go.
Mitch,
oh, come
no.
on, I need to do it.
No.
To make Sky happy. No,
no,
it didn't work.
Does it look like that would make me happy? No. You may not be able to see my face right now.
All right, we finished World 5. I did it for you guys. I did it for chat.
Yeah, you finished World 6 at 41:02, by the way, to keep things in perspective.
Okay, so I need, like, special P-speed strategies. So this is, like, Tar, I guess. Do you guys remember Super Mario Sunshine with, like... It's, like, the blacks... It's really hard to swim. It's super heavy in this game. If anything, I'll just go up here just so I can fly across all this goop. I'm not a fan of goop.
No.
I don't like goop. Too sticky, you know, all over the place. It's like, yeah, it's like weird Tar stuff. So this world is like Mario. Oh, you see how it like pushes you down? This is Mario Sunshine, this level.
Whee.
I don't know where this design specifically comes from. Okay. We made it. That level would have gone much different if I had a penguin suit to use, but I'm kind of saving my power-ups right now for mistakes. Can I tail swipe him? Yes, I can.
I was gonna say, you're asking me this question when you're the one who ran the game, because, again, Pass Mitch is kinda rocking it over there.
That's why I gave the estimate, because, like, this game is... It's not short, and it's very sequential. you don't have the right power up, you don't have the right sequence in the level, you're losing a lot of time. And I just got grabbed by him. You know, we'll get this coin. Also, hey, this game has the hold fly. You just hold A and you instantly fly. Mario 3 also does not have that. This level's very short, though, so we don't want to have to struggle too much. I know you guys are really pulling for me, aren't you? I bet you guys are. Come on, Mitch, you can do it. While all of you guys are, you know, pass Mitch, go.
Those of y'all in chat, are you rooting for the timer or are you rooting for Mitch right now? We'll see where people are rooting for right now.
Okay, so this level is a very high speedrun level. You need to have, like, Fire Flower to shoot those guys and build P-Speed. And this level can go by very fast, but without P-Speed strats, it's not going to go fast. Okay, I got the Fire Flower. Maybe I can build it here. Come on, hit something. Oh, I got a little bit. Come on!
Some people said okay. Pass Mitch. You can't root for Pass Mitch. Spoiler alert, Pass Mitch is going to win most of the time. Unless Mitch has been practicing, then we have a whole nother issue if that's the case. So no, you cannot.
Discrepancy in episode 2.
Yeah, you can't root for Pass Mitch. That's not part of the deal. It's the timer versus Mitch here.
I don't know what the enemies are. I knew that there was enemies right at the end, but I didn't know where. Okay. I lost, like,
nice
at least
mix.
Half a minute there.
You have a nice mix, though, of people rooting for Mitch and rooting for the timer. There's a little bit of both going on in the chat right now.
Oh, I don't know where the ledge is. Okay, right here.
You were talking about this level earlier, Mitch.
Yeah, not this one. There is another one, though.
Okay, alright. Same premise, though.
But this one does have intense P-Speed strategies that, by not taking for myself, I'm losing a lot of time. I could go in there to get a Firefly, but it is a waste of time, so I'm not going to go in there. Get the checkpoint. All right. Oh, come on. Yes. So we got this guy who can be pretty buggy sometimes, which is why I really wanted to make sure I had... There we go. And then now he'll ground pound on me. Boom. Got him.
Yeah, PD can be kind of temperamental sometimes. And the hitboxes, I remember, on PD in particular are really bad.
Yeah, they're really, really strange. That's right. Again, no penguin suit, so this level is not gonna see creatures all the time. Okay, I think I go bottom path here. With penguin suit, I don't have to go bottom path, but I think here I should. Oh, the fireball went over him, but I still got P-Speed. Do I keep it? Go!
Nope.
I didn't get to keep it. I got so much time that I need to...
It looks like you're still well within the timer right now. I think it's pretty alright so far.
Okay, so this guy... Fireflower... Wait, I don't think I need Fire Flower for this. Now the run's getting intense, because I really have to pay attention to what power-ups I'm using and what I'm not using.
You have to pay attention to what's in your inventory.
Exactly. So, here we go.
Ooh, this looks familiar. Hello, 7-4.
That's right, sea creatures. Yeah. Are we getting any sea creature emotes in chat?
Oh yeah, we're seeing a lot of... I can definitely tell who watches your channel because we're getting the sea creatures in here. I know who the Mitch Flower Power fans are in here.
Mitch Flower Power gang?
Yeah.
Alright, we're actually not doing so bad. I really enjoyed this concept that you have with the Mercy Kill. I'm having a lot of fun, and I really hope everyone else who's watching is also having a lot of fun. Yeah, you really did great work here, Sky. This is fun.
Thanks! I've actually had this idea for quite a few years, but I figured, you know, now is a time as good as any.
Yeah. And, like, the thing that I enjoy the most is that even though I do have a 140, like, I'm still trying to go fast because, like, I still want to put up a good time in comparison, but at the same time, if I do too many risky plays, I can really, really get messed up here. So I'm playing it very safe this run. Very, very safe.
Yeah, so again, for those of you who are new here, I see a lot of new people here. This is episode 2 of Mercy Kill on the GDQ Hotfix, and the premise behind the show is we ask speedrunners to run some of their rustiest games that they have. Not polished practice stuff. You can watch marathons for the polished practice things. I'm talking about the things we haven't seen in years. And that is what the show is. The runner assigns an estimate. They choose the estimate. The only time I intervene is when I want to make a suggestion for something, if they make it too generous or too tight. But they're supposed to be able to beat the timer. If they don't finish the run within the estimate, if you see the estimate up in the upper left-hand corner, it is 140. If Mitch does not finish before that 140, run's over. We're not going to let Mitch finish. That's it. The timer wins. And that's we move on to the next game. And which tonight, there is a double feature thanks to Mitch. There will be a Mega Man 3 after this, which is sold. We don't have a past Mitch for Mega Man 3.
Yeah, we don't even have a run.
So there's no past Mitch. It's just Mitch trying to remember whatever he can about Mega Man 3. So that's going to be hilarious. So that is the basic premise behind the show. And Mitch is being an awesome sport in A, doing this, and B, agreeing to do 2 runs for that. And our current record right now for Mercy Kill, we've only had 1 other episode so far. We are 1-0 in terms of save to kill. Kizaron did save the Pokemon Red run last week, despite having the save corruption, so we'll see. We'll see if we get to save both runs tonight, or if we have our first ever Mercy Kill.
Please. Please, 3Vix, go easy on me. So, like, I have to already be in World 7 now, right? On the other video. Easily.
Yeah, 52 minutes flat was your World 7. Thank you, Gunchat. Appreciate it.
So this right here, this is what I was talking about. This is like 3-minute time loss here. Because in the speedrun, this is one of the biggest tricks, biggest time saves, is you strategically fly over doing very precise flying, which obviously I wouldn't remember after a couple years, so I now have to go through this. And even the previous level, there's a single frame jump at the start, which skips the entire level, which I also didn't get, so that was another like 45 seconds lost.
Yes, now this is the level you were referring to earlier.
That's right. I've got nothing. It's so slow, look at this. Look at how slow this thing goes.
This is such a this is slower than the 7-4 auto scroller, and that's saying right. Something.
This is like the slowest scroll in the game.
So don't die here is what that means.
That's exactly what it means. As long as I don't fart around, that'd be pretty good. I'm not mucking around.
Past Mitch is playing Mega Man 3 DOS. No, it's not the DOS version of Mega Man 3. It's just gonna be playing the NES version.
I'm sure Javon would know exactly how much this here loses, because he was actually the one who developed this. In the original speedruns, it always had this, and then he found a fly for this, so he probably knows really well. Okay, I thought I missed my A press there. That would be really bad. I don't want to lose Fire Flower. The levels are starting to get really blind for me, so I'm actually kind of getting a little nervous here.
I don't think it's slower than the World 4 Airship in Mario 3. I don't think anything can be slower than the World 4 Airship in
That's
Mario
true.
3.
The scroll itself is slower than the World 4 scroll, but the World 4 is, like, much longer section.
To give you all an idea, during an actual marathon run, and I'm sure Mitch remembers this, we took a selfie on the World 4 Airship. That's how slow that level is, and that was during a marathon.
I know. Cujo dropped his phone, too. I thought the console was going to freeze. I was so scared.
I remember that. It's a while ago. Oh, another Petey fight.
Come on, Petey. Ah! Okay, I'm safe.
There you go.
That was my scare cry right there. I was very... Okay.
No, Cujo did not stomp the console. No. No.
I am a 2-time stomp victim, so...
No.
Please watch what you say about the stomps.
I hope Pooh's not here right now. He'd feel really bad.
Good! He should. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, he should feel bad. He's the equivalent, you know.
We love you, Pooh. We don't mean it.
I had therapy for like a couple months after.
Pooh's our buddy.
So But this one, you actually, it's weird. You'd go right back into the pipe, which from some of the Mario 3 editing that I've... Okay, he just disappeared. All right. But yeah, from my editing of Mario 3 that I've done before, the pointers do not work like that, so that's very impressive. Mm-hmm. You go in one pipe and you go back in that pipe, it'll take you, you know. Okay, so what do we got here? Boss. Oh yeah, there's a quick kill.
Another Bowser Jr.
Oh, I didn't get it.
Was there another quick kill here?
There was, but I didn't get it. I tried for it, and now I'm scared.
I'll let you focus here.
This is actually a pretty tough battle.
Mm-hmm.
So he always drops the fire where you are, and I don't know where he drops the bombs, but sometimes you can get stuck. Oh. No, I knew it. He threw it to the left, too. Okay, what do we have here? Something. I need anything. I'm going to have to start going to Mushroom Houses soon.
Someone said, someone go tell Pooh Mitch is talking stuff about him. That's not a surprise to Pooh, I'll tell you now. Me, Pooh, and Mitch have known each other for a while. That's no surprise there.
Yeah, I'm sure the chatter's kidding, because, like, yeah, I've talked to Pooh every once in a while. We joke about it.
Oh, yeah.
If you guys are curious, yes, he does still feel guilty.
Yes, he does. That is true. As one of his friends, he very much feels that way.
No, I can see what I mean. This boss battle is so annoying. It's because he always drops them. Okay, what do I have here?
I was gonna say, look in the inventory to see if you got anything to help out.
This is not an easy battle.
I have firm belief you got this.
I gotta watch for the bombs, okay? Oh, see, I'm kinda stuck. Let me out. Alright, I think I got, like, a nice groove here. I think I'm gonna do a left-right here as well. Oh, gosh. Yep. No! The fire! Come on, I need something! I'll use Fire Flower. This is all payback for talking smack. I shouldn't have talked no smack. I should be safe here. I had like a nice setup there.
I definitely would think I wouldn't call you being safe until we get past this. This looks really, really, really difficult.
Yeah, the platforms here are kind of what make it stressful. Because that's big Mario. You don't have much room for movement right here. So it gets a little... Okay, I should be good here. Yeah, nice. Easy kill. Oh, what? The triple? I didn't even know he did that. Mainly because fast kill. Off-screen wand grab? I'll do it. Give me that off-screen wand grab. Come on, game. No off-screen wand grab. I tried to catch the wand, though. Alright, we made it! Now, the hard world. This is where it gets really intense.
Seven's difficult for you?
Yeah, it's got lost levels in it and stuff like that.
Ooh.
It's got upside
I know all
down
about
stuff.
Those. I like lost levels. Doo-doo!
So this is Mario Galaxy theme?
So how you feeling? How you feeling so far, Mitch, about how everything's going? You're almost at the hour mark. You got 40 minutes to go to beat the timer.
I don't need that power up. I'm feeling pretty good. I don't know how long this world's going to take me, though. Because I will try and speedrun it, obviously, but we'll see. With the gravity and stuff, there's so many blind jumps, and you never know. Come on, get off the hill. Okay. I think we made it.
Woo!
I love the flipping, the upside down and stuff. It's so fun. God, it's so fun.
Woo! Yeah, Southburg did a really great job with the physics, especially in this world.
Okay, this is the level that I need to not... This is a lost level?
Mm-hmm. It sure
so I
is.
Need to be very careful here. I think I go up here.
I run this game. Well, not this, not Remix, but I actually run Lost Levels still.
OK. Okay, I survived there. What do I do? Drop right there. Okay. Alright, I'm in.
I wasn't gonna say anything, but yeah.
Is that there in Lost Levels, that exact thing?
I don't think so, no. I don't think there's anything there, actually, so...
Oh god, so a little generous for me, huh?
Yeah, that's pretty generous.
I knew there was the Goombas there. I even slowed down, too. They got me. I love the color tone of the piranha plants, though, in the underground theme. They look really nice. Like the kind of dark reddish there.
Mm-hmm.
They look really nice. Oh, that is not the way to go. I got the coin, though.
Yeah, some people were asking earlier about what the coins did in this game.
Yeah, so you have to collect all the coins to unlock a secret world. There's three coins in every level. And then once you beat the game, you actually have to go back through the game one more time, and there's comet levels. Much like in Super Mario Galaxy, how you have those comet missions. Mm-hmm. You have to do the same thing. No, not Bowser. I need power-ups. No! What did I get? Two power-ups, I think?
Pass Mitch is about to finish!
Pass Mitch thinks he's so good with his little speed strats.
I don't know, Pass Mitch looks pretty confident here. Got a big smile on Pass Mitch right now.
Big smile, huh?
Very intense smile, but it's a big smile.
Yeah, I think that was a really, really tight world record at the time. There's some, like, new strategies even right now. There's, like, a big skip in this world that I don't even know how to do yet. Oh, no.
Oh.
That just happened. I just, like, slid right in there.
Yeah, right in. Yeah, this is after the Frost Flame Galaxy in Super Mario Galaxy.
I'm just gonna concentrate for a second here.
Okay.
'Cause I need this. There's a lot of blinds here. I do the turn here. Yup.
Yep.
So yeah, I'm not gonna slide here, but there's a lot of blind jumps right here in this section. Yeah, that's where I just died, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then
you're past it.
There's another blind jump. Oh my gosh, I almost died right there. It's very close. Okay, I think I'm safe.
Someone asked, how is this mod casually? I would highly encourage, if you've beaten, like, Mario 1, Mario 2, Mario 3, Mario World, if you've beaten, like, any of those, you can do this.
This is an incredible casual, mod. It, what makes it so, look, guys, but we gotta do it upside down.
That's awesome.
But you guys know I know this level too well, so.
Yeah.
I mean,
well.
You're not gonna see many mistakes from me in this level. Oh!
Yeah, this is 1-5 from Mario 3.
Right. Oh. Okay. Gotta go in the pipe. But yeah, as a casual playthrough for this, amazing. It's like it's total adventure, lots of exploring. It goes through games that you recognize and levels that you know a little bit, and there's lots of different secrets, lots of different exits too. Really, really good. We got ladders. I mean, come on, ladders, right?
Yeah, what are those ladders doing there?
Yeah, get out of your ladders. Oh, man. It's a really fun sky. I'm having a lot of fun right now. Thank you so much.
Well, I should say that's good for everyone who's enjoying themselves. You're supposed to be feeling a little nervous right now, but you know what? If you can be fun and nervous. That's
yeah,
that's
exactly. I deal with nerves differently.
Yeah, you do.
A good example is that every single GDQ performance that I've ever done, oh my gosh, I've been incredibly nervous all the time.
Well, don't you remember, when you did Kaizo, in between every single level, you looked over at me at the hosting station, you were waving and giving me thumbs up and giving me goofy faces.
Right? And like, I'm so nervous, I have massive stage fright, and I think I kind of shrug it off by being silly and, you know, just kind of taking the pressure off. Like, that's what I like to do most. But yeah, a lot of people don't know. Every GDQ performance, I'm always so nervous. And, right, I always have my stage fright. I've always had stage fright.
You've always had fun, though, too. I've always noticed that.
Exactly.
It never got in the way of your fun. You may have been nervous, but it never got in the way of you playing some Mario 3.
Okay, so this section I know is pretty easy. You just run straight, so no fears there. Right down the hills. Come on. All the jumps and... What? Okay. I twisted back. I thought I survived, but no, I didn't. Okay, I need to use the tail here for safety. Alright, let's try that.
Some of these jumps.
I know, there's so many. Dude, and the gravity too is throwing me around. I'm all over the place.
Yeah.
And I know that section is like... Oh, come on, this really? Okay, I'll just get P-speed. I thought there'd be at least a hidden block there to like let you get up, but nope. Alright, let's try this again. Okay, I'm definitely not gonna slide. I'm gonna take it slow here. Oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh, there's a little bit of lag it looks like in that part.
Oh yeah, every level in this game lags. Right after everyone figures... Oh look, it's like a person here. Right after everyone figures out all the speed strats, the next step for this game is like de-lag strats. I know the Tassers had a lot of trouble with this game trying to get rid of lag strats. Easy. So this next level has a massive skip in it that I don't know how to do, so I can't do it, unfortunately. You do some weird upside down flying, and it somehow gets you pretty much to the end of the level.
Oh wow.
Yeah. It's pretty new. I think Aerobam is the one who created it, if I'm trying to give the right shoutouts to everyone. Nice try, Turtle. I just like ran right through it. Yeah, see you later, Turtle. Okay, so now I do the slides. Whee! Oh, come on, I got stuck in the hill there. Alright, here we go. Upside down strats, avoid the hills. It's gonna get really laggy right here.
Alright, that's too many Koopas on the screen.
Too many turtles, that's right. Alright, nice. Nicely done. Almost flagpole glitch. How am I doing so far? I'm trying to go faster and faster,
well,
but...
Pass Mitch finished about 5 minutes ago or so.
So I'm at almost a 110 right now?
You're at 107.32 right now.
Okay.
You didn't sound enthused by that. You're just like, alright.
I know. Well, I'm trying to... Okay, this section's really annoying.
Ooh.
We got through it, though, but I am small, so I'm gonna have to go really slow here. Oh, if I played that right, I should've got the power-up first. But I'm not thinking! What do you guys think of the cute little space guys? Little saucers. This bullet has been on here forever! Get out of here, bullet!
Wait,
it's been on the screen.
Those saucers are from Kirby's Adventure. Those are the UFO sprites.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they're from, like, the Mario Galaxy as well,
mm-hmm.
I think is what the copy is. Okay, I almost died. Wow, he woke up so fast!
Wow, yeah, that wasn't a lot of time at all.
Okay, last power up. There should be a mushroom house here, though, that I can take. Yeah, look at how long he's, right? And then all of a sudden, he woke up so fast. Even there, I had a lot of time, and then here... what? Why is one already frozen? What is this game?
Mitch, stop breaking the game.
Okay, here we go. I think I do 8? Ooh, you guys are gonna like this level, I think. Yeah, look at this. We all know what this level is.
Oh yeah. Looks a lot nicer than the Mario 3 counterpart.
You think so? Because the blue? Ooh.
Well, you're not scrolling, and it looked like if you wanted that power-up at the beginning, it wasn't impossible like it is in Mario 3.
Oh my gosh, this fireball! Just get out of the screen! It's still there! Dude, the same as the bullet bill. Okay. I don't think this was the right level to take. But I did get a power-up. Oh, I can squeeze through there. Yeah, we made it. Okay. Nope, not up there. This actually isn't even the level I took in the PB. We learned that the other level instead of this one has much faster strategies in it, with some like pipes and stuff, but I did not remember that. A lot of rusty speedruns are remembering too. That's what I'm getting hit with the most right now, trying to remember which section and where to go. Like that swimming section was kind of like a maze. All right, I need this.
I was going to save this for the second interview section, but I'm going to ask this now. Were there any other Rusty runs that you would consider playing for this format in the future? Was there anything that you thought of?
Yeah, I really think Kaizo SMB3 would be a good one as well. 3-Mix, I knew I would be Rusty, but I guess in terms of estimates, it would be really hard to tell, because even now I still don't know exactly when I'm going to finish because of all this stuff. But Kaizo SMB3, as a lot of people know from Kaizo, it doesn't matter even how rusty or unrusty you are, sometimes you just can't beat the levels, right? So it's like it's a tricky situation. So I would like to come back for another episode at some time in the future if you guys would have me, because this is a lot of fun. And also, it kind of helps revitalize speedruns, in my opinion, because...
Yeah,
you know,
that's one
I'm...
of the questions I ask. Would you consider, after playing this today, would you consider running it again at some point?
Of course, because it's a good opportunity for me to be like, what haven't I run in a while? And then I think about it, I'm like, you know what, I'm going to run that again, but why don't I showcase it as well with Sky?
Yeah.
And then try and do the Mercy Kill and see how I do. And then it's like a good introduction of like, what do I need to practice if I want to get back into these runs?
No, this has been awesome so far. And again, I'm always looking for show ideas. So that's why I always ask people at the end of these, at the end of the shows, you know, would you consider running another, either this game in your own personal stream, just to see if it made a difference. And then what other runs are you interested in playing Rusty first? Because remember, once you de-rust, it's a little less interesting. That's why I always ask people about Mercy Kill first. They're like, should I play it? I'm like, why don't you be on the show first and then you can run it if you wanted to.
Yeah, exactly.
After.
I think so too. And this show also provides some insight into, like, and you get asked this a lot as a speedrunner, like, oh, you know, what were your PBs like a couple years ago, and what do you do to, like, de-rust and stuff like that, and, like, this is a great showcase, the show, you know?
It certainly shows that if you don't maintain a speedrun, it's very difficult to keep the same skill level that you had back when you did run it. A lot of people think, oh, a speedrunner learned something once and we remember every single thing about that. Absolutely not. Between learning other games, playing other games, real life things. I mean, a lot of stuff falls by the wayside in these speedruns, and if they're not properly maintained, it's easy to forget a lot of things.
Exactly. It is very easy to forget. There's a lot of things that I've forgotten in this run, but some things I didn't forget, like, it's very important to keep that power up for World 4 and World 5, but I mean, I just couldn't, because there's a lot of tricks, right? And you're trying to go fast, and the cycles, it just gets crazy. It gets out of hand, right? You start losing time, and then you start losing more time, and then you start losing more time, and it like, crumbles, right? And that's how... It goes to show, like, how incredible speedruns are when somebody, like, think of Mario 64, right?
Mm-hmm.
You maintain your momentum for, like, a full hour straight. Like, just that, even if you don't get the world record, like, that itself is incredible because, oh my gosh. A good example right there. Like, the turtle came out of nowhere. All right.
By the way, about 26 minutes remain until the Mercy Kill happens. So just keep that in mind, about 26 minutes or so.
You were nervous there at the start. I was trying to tell you guys, like, there's, I still have like 4 more auto scrollers and then the rest of World 8. I tried to tell you guys, man, Mario SMB 3 mixes is a force. Oh no, I'm gonna die for sure. I think I have to wait. I have to wait for him to shoot. Yep, there they are. Please don't. Okay, good. So there is a speed strat for this where you can go right away, but there are weird shots that he does where as soon as you go to jump, he shoots, and then he'll tag you. And that's what happened on the second cycle, but thankfully not on the third. Thankfully.
Hey, it's Rosalina. Alright, world 7 clear. One more world. You have about 25 minutes.
Well, Bowser's Castle is over 2 minutes, for sure. So I have less than that. And this is a very, very high sequential speedrun level that if you don't memorize, you guys remember, this is 8-1 from Mario 1. So there's a lot of enemy placements you have to remember. So I'm not even going to try and go for P-Speed because I know it won't work and I'll end up dying.
Okay, not only is it 8-1, it's 8-1 with lag. Look at that.
I know, look at this. And I'm afraid that the collision detection won't register, and I'll go right through enemies, too. So I'm trying to stay alive here. This really has some Mario 1 feels to it right now. There should be a star there, yep. It's like, no,
whoa,
I need this so bad.
You don't like it when that goes in the other direction.
No. Okay, I need this as well. Okay. So it's gonna be like 8-1, 8-2, and 8-3 almost. Okay, yep, the one tile there. I think there's something back here for me. Yep, I didn't really need that. I was kind of hoping it was a power-up. We don't need one-ups right now.
Need the big one-ups.
Okay, so I have Peach Speed Strat, so I'm going to go for them. Oh, I didn't keep it, though. I was going to... Wow, that Hammer Brother.
Well, that was a thing.
Oh, I almost got... I tried to do it again. It didn't work out.
Oh!
Come on, HBs.
This level's making me nervous, friend. Alright.
Thank goodness. This is one of the most important levels in the world record run. If you do it perfectly with P-Speed strats versus not doing it perfectly, it's like easily 20 seconds. It's incredible. Oh, I don't have a power-up to do- No, I have to die.
So now we're in Wart's Castle right now. Mm-hmm. For Mario 2.
Yep, but I have to die because I need a power-up to do a glitch. So I don't have to do the whole castle.
Same way how we skip it in vanilla SMB2, I assume. You want to get past the majority of these rooms. We ladder clip typically, but I assume you're going to be doing a wall clip.
Well, come on. Yeah, there we go.
Wow, you don't have... Oh, is that like the people's clip from Mario 3's castle? Because that's what that looked like to me.
No. This one's like to activate this boss. It's so glitchy right here. It's weird. So that's why I had to die, because I was small Mario. I would never have been able to... I think I can do a moonwalk glitch, too. Yeah. Moonwalk, baby! Da-da-da-da-da-da. Alright, we made it.
Alright.
Okay, and here's more auto-scrollers. You guys should know what this level is. I'll give you guys a couple minutes.
Yeah, I won't say it. I'll let
them. Yeah, we'll see if the crowd can guess this level.
Yeah.
So even though I am dressed up like the Tanuki, I am not Tanuki Mario. I cannot turn into the statue right now. Yay, no coin ships, thank goodness.
Yeah, a couple people did get the correct answer here. In the chat, I'm seeing it. Except this one isn't as slippery as the other one is in spots.
That's right. If I get a chance, I'm going to do a little Easter egg right there for my... Yep. It's one up right here, too. Come on, one up.
I was going to caution you against walking into a hole after the one up.
Right? I've done it before. I've been... Oh, dude, the things that I've done is...
The things that you've done for the people.
Yes. I was nervous. So here's a nice little P-Speed strategy. Come on. Okay, I made it.
Have you bonked that section... there?
What's that?
Have you bonked into that hole before?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. So there's a section there. If I would have hit the switch there... I kind of would have got a little knocked, and I would have had a chance to probably perish. Come on, Yoshi. Whee. Where am I? What the heck? All right.
Oh, that
I'd
works.
Expect nothing less from a Mario game. Just, you know, you randomly spawn the ground, and there's some flying fish. How did they come up with that in the Mario Studios, do you think? They're like, I know, we can have fish that have always wanted to be flying, so let's just have some flying fish.
I think they just wanted something so wild and so different that was going to catch the attention of people.
And it totally did. I mean, you have this weird monster inside of a cloud throwing spiked shell things. Go Lactu. Okay,
coming close to about 20 minutes, Mitch. Don't cut it too much closer. You're gonna make all of us nervous over here.
I know, I have, Oh, wait. Oh, come on. There's a secret exit there, but I can't get it. So I'm gonna have to OG strats here.
DLC.
Alright, here we go, guys. First boomerang, and it's gone. Come on. Wait, is there another? How do I get through there? I need the boomerang suit. That's actually pretty clever. I probably could have damage boost. There's another one right here, though. We're gonna go for swag strats. Got him. Look at that. I'm gonna let the fireballs go off the screen, because you guys know it's from last time. Oh. I forgot that enemy was there. Nice, we made it.
Nice.
Let's
go. We got the one up. Alright, so I assume that castle there, that's the end, right? I see a pipe on the other side of the screen, but I assume you don't go into that.
Yeah, that's for special world.
Okay.
And then you do special world, and then if you... Yeah, look at that. Look at me go.
Ooh.
That's actually a world record strat. You want to get that a couple second time save.
Ooh, another auto-scroller, though, across LEGO land here.
There's three more auto-scrollers.
I think you got this, Mitch. I don't wanna jinx it, but I think you got this.
Well, how much time do I have left?
You are at 121.40 with an estimate of 140, so about 19, almost 18 minutes left.
Okay, and then we still at least have 4 minutes of auto-scrollers.
Yes. I'm glad you didn't give me 130. I would definitely be way more nervous if you gave me 130 instead of 140 here.
Yeah, I think my estimate was pretty reasonable. A lot of the bad things... I actually died more than I thought I was going to die with silly, questionable mistakes. Like, I thought I would be safe in certain spots, but I wasn't. But still, so much can happen right now.
Oh, yeah. Alright. Just random auto-scroller in World 8. That seems like SMB3-esque to me.
Thought I was gonna die there. I also thought I was gonna die there.
I thought you were just goofing off, honestly. I didn't realize that actually...
No!
Oh.
My A press. I pressed, I swear. Go safe.
So again, folks, right after Mitch is finished with this game, we are going to be taking a quick break, and then we are going to have another interview asking Mitch about what a lot of us are probably wondering is, Mitch, you actually speedrun something that's not Mario 3 related. How and why? I want to know more behind the lore of the Mitch Flower Power that has done speedruns of Mega Man 3 that were apparently so old they are not on speedrun.com, and we do not have any records of said speedrun. So that's going to be interesting. I think this is the last level.
This is the last level, that's right.
But this level is long from what I can remember.
Very long. Yeah, this auto-scroller right here itself, I think, is just 2 minutes. And then you have the castle. Yeah, so I don't know. I guess I was a little cautious of the... mercy kill. However... It was very hard for me to, you know, kind of, you know, where, I didn't know exactly where I was going to die or what I would mess up or what I would even remember, so, yeah.
That's right, I think it makes up for your, what I feel like is not a generous estimate for your next game.
50 minutes is going to be pretty stressful.
It is. I mean, I'm just thinking about it, thinking about what the implications are for game overing in that game, and it feels stressful to me. And I've never even played that Mega Man before. I've only played 2.
Yeah, Mega Man 3 is not a kind game. This game's pretty rough on you. And, right? That's why I did the estimates the way I did. Like, 3-mix, like, again, with the game that I know and that I speedrun, I know anything can happen. With Mega Man 3, I mean, I only know what I know, and that's all I'm going to do. So, it's going to be very difficult. With Mario 3, there's so many different, you know, close calls that I'll have, and oh my gosh, I can't believe I made that kind of thing. With Mega Man, I don't think I'm going to have those. I think it's just going to be, well, I knew I was going to die there.
I will say Mega Man 3 seems like a pretty reasonable game to do. I would dread to think, I used to speedrun Castlevania 3, and that is not a great game for me to be put on a timer like that. So at least you don't have like a Castlevania game staring at you in the face right now, because my goodness.
Castlevania 3 is scary.
Yeah, it is. It very much is. But the Mega Man games, I know the Game Over system isn't as generous in those if I remember them the way I do, but I think there's passwords. I think, again, it's been a while since I've even seen Mega Man 3.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to be trying to get some lives here in Mega Man 3, and I'm going to want to... Oh, come on. Oh, I got the yump. Does this power-up come back, though? I'm curious. I hope it does. Yes, it does.
Okay. Are there any checkpoints in this level?
Yes. After you do the auto-scroller, there's a checkpoint right there, and then right before the Bowser battle, there's a checkpoint.
Well, that's good.
Yeah, knowing your way around this fortress is, it's a very good thing. I mean, do you see that question mark in the wall? Like, if you don't spawn that pipe, that's all it gives you is a question mark. I mean, how helpful is that? So, oh, come on. I, like, slid. Here, let's get rid of this guy. Boom. Okay, is he gonna... See you later, buddy. See you later, buddy. They're all just fall into the holes. Oh, yeah, we want to get rid of that guy. He's very dangerous. Okay, we'll get rid of this guy. I think I drop here. Yep. It's a useless star. Gotta love him. No somersaults, though. What rip, right? I think I'm gonna go this way. Back up.
This is such a maze.
I know. I activated a switch that's going to release the thing. Right there, yeah. We all know this music.
Mm-hmm.
And you cannot fire kill Bowser in this.
So the boss fight alone then will take some time.
A little bit of time.
Let me know when time is.
Time is as soon as the screen goes black, if I remember correctly.
Okay.
See you later, Bowser. All right, what's my time right now?
Right now, you're at 1:27:49.
That's still pretty close. That's actually not too far off. If you think about it, all it takes is a couple deaths and auto-scrollers. Boom, right there.
All right, 1:28 on the nose. Get your GGs out for Mitch. We have our first saved run of the night, SMB3 Mix, Any% by Mitch Flower Power. Congratulations on escaping the Mercy Kill Gauntlet. However, there will be another one right after this.
All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to wait another 3 years, and then I'll come back for episode 400, and I'll set the Mercy Kill time to a 1:30.
Yeah, I would like to see the 1:30 would have been... I think I would have been sweating on the 1:30, I won't lie.
Oh, it's... You know, if you haven't run it in a while, it's very hard to properly estimate. I tried.
Mm-hmm.
But, side note, we still have Mega Man 3 plus... That one is less than an hour. I don't know if I'll make it.
That one's gonna be very interesting. So, couple announcements here before we go to the break. So, I have a couple announcements, then we're going to take a quick break where Mitch is going to switch games. We're going to do another interview segment because there's a lot I want to know about Mitch running a Mega Man game. I'm sorry, this is too big for me to not ask a few questions with that, all right? And then we'll go into the second Mercy Kill game of the night, which will be Mitch Flower Bower versus the Mega Man 3 not-so-generous timer. So, real quick, remember that GDQ Hotfix, as well as Mercy Kill, is brought to you by viewers like you. If you'd like to support the stream, as well as the other programs on GDQ Hotfix, please consider subbing to the channel. If you have Amazon Prime, remember you have a Twitch Prime sub, please consider using it if you have not already to sub to the channel and support Hotfix. And remember too, real quick, SGDQ 2020 Online will be August 16th through the 23rd, with the schedule released on July 13th. You can go to gamesdonequick.com for more info on SGDQ news. All right, we're going to take a quick break, folks. When we get back, I'm going to be interviewing Mitch, and then we're going to be going straight into Mega Man 3 after that interview. We'll see you soon, folks. Whee! right, welcome back to GDQ Hot Fix. This is Mercy Kill. I'm Sky Bills, your host. I'm here with Mitch Flower Power, who's all pumped after that run. Mitch is ready to go.
Oh, yeah.
So, real quick here, a couple announcements. Tomorrow at 7 p.m. Eastern, we'll be having Resident Evil 2 Remake on the first step. So that'll be Kizaron and J-Hobbs. Very, very, very excited about that. For more info on GDQ Hot Fix shows, as well as how to submit your runs, go to gamesdonequick.com/hotfix. And with that, Mitch, how are you feeling right now? How did everything go with SMB3 Mix?
Honestly, with SMB3 Mix, I feel like everything went way better than I thought it was. I get that the estimate was a little generous with the 140, but as I was mentioning before, there, you know, when I was creating that estimate, I was thinking to myself, there are some auto scrollers and there are some tricks where if you die or lose out on some times, or even miss a checkpoint. I mean, we're talking minutes, and I still had already accidentally taken an exit and done an extra level. So just that alone, those two little things there set me back so much time, you know, not having that. But I had a blast. It was great. I had a lot of fun. I hope everyone else had a lot of fun, too. It was. I hope you guys got to watch me be rusty at Mario 3. It won't happen all the time.
No, it won't. It's something you certainly don't get to see quite often. So we'll also have Richard here on comms. Richard, who works for the GDQ staff. That'll be awesome to have his input as he's run Mega Man 3 in the past. I got a couple questions from Richard before we start here. So Richard asks, what are your thoughts on the stage order that you're going for? And remember, as a reminder, folks, there are three major routes in Mega Man 3. There's Gemini First, which is the slowest, also one of the oldest strats. Magnet First, which is the next slowest, a bit newer, but widely considered the safest. And Top First, newest and slightly risky. Which one are you going for, Mitch?
I'm going to go, you know, I don't even remember what the route was, but I knew there was something weird with Top First and Gemini First, and I couldn't remember which one was the what, so I'm just going to go with Top First, because from my memories of running this so long ago, it actually used to be Top First a very, very long time ago, and then it was Gemini First for the longest time, and then it actually went back to Top First, so I think I'm just going to do Top First, and then kind of work my way there. I don't even know. You know, I'm going to fight Top and see what happens.
So, same question as earlier. What inspired you to run this game in the first place? And was it a mistake to learn? You may feel differently about this after you've been put through the Mercy Kill Gauntlet with Mega Man 3, but what are your thoughts on that?
Mega Man 3 is so good. It's the music is... I love Mega Man games, just in general. I mean, I did speedruns of Mega Man 1. I did speedruns of Mega Man 2 before any of the zips were created. I did speedruns of Mega Man 3 and 4. I've done speedruns of Mega Man 9. I did speedruns of Mega Man 10 base mode. It just, it's, Mega Man's great. It's one of my favorite series out there. And the retro versions of Mega Man, they're so good. Right?
It's... So, for the record, when was your last completed run of this game? And again, this is not on SRC. You will not find this information.
Probably around 2015 or 16.
Oh my gosh, Mitch.
No, actually, hold on. I did do a completed run, I think, at a GDQ in 2017 with a bunch of the Mega Man 3 guys. They were putting a tournament together. You know how GDQ works, where you get like 15 mm-hmm. TVs and it's like one game and it's like a big tournament? I think I did one of those in 2017 or so, but I can't even remember.
So we have your PB at a 37, played 4 years ago. Your estimate, now again, let's think about the ratio here, okay? To put things in perspective, the SMB3 mix we just witnessed, Mitch had a 102.38 there, and we had a 140 estimate. Seems pretty straightforward. This is a 37-minute PB with a 50-minute estimate. Mitch, I don't know about this one.
Just thinking
I'm
about
be complete.
Those numbers,
something
please.
Doesn't add up here, Mitch, especially
somebody
given...
I know. Yeah, my 3-mix PB is a 102, and I just got a 127, so, yeah, good perspective.
Given
I don't know what I'm doing, guys, help me. Somebody
given,
needs to hold me.
Given the punishment of dying in game overs, I'm going to say, I don't know, Mitch. I don't know, and I don't think so. We'll see, though. I mean, I would like to be 3-0 for saves here, but this one is by far looking like the most difficult challenge yet. Is there anything else you would like to talk about with Mega Man 3? Before you run this, and any other words you have for the chat?
Well, let me just remind everyone, I did speed run this game, so I do know some things. So I mean, this isn't my first time playing, so we'll see how it goes.
Well,
I'm going to be concentrating a lot more on this run for everyone. If you're wondering, I'm, you know, Mario 3 is just second nature for me. I don't even have to watch the TV sometimes, humble brag. But with Mega Man 3, I can't do that. I can't do that.
Well, we're now are at the moment we've all been waiting for. Folks, Mitch Flower Power, 2020 Mega Man 3, 50-minute estimate. We'll see how this goes. I'm very excited. Good luck and have fun, Mitch. We'll get ready to count you down in a second here. And we'll have Richard here on commentary as well, who knows so much about Mega Man 3. So I'm looking forward to hearing some of the facts about this game. Mitch, are you ready to go?
I'm ready to go.
All right. I'm nervous here just to hit the start button. But
I'm
here
actually
kind of
nervous too.
Oh my goodness. All right, here we go. In 3, 2, 1, go! Good luck, and see if you can escape the Mercy Kill Gauntlet. 50 minutes! Go for it.
I'm gonna try here. Alright, Mega Man 3 has slide for anyone.
One of the things about this game, hello everyone, this is Richard, the restreamer for Mercy Kill, and actually, you're gonna be seeing my PV in the bottom left, which is a 38.59. We'll see how Mitch does in this very mashing intensive stage. That's one of the things about Mega Man 3 that puts it in a special place in the Mega Man games. The game after this, Mega Man 4, had the charge shot, but this one, you just have to mash through everything. So there are going to be a couple enemies later on in this stage where he's going to be mashing really hard. On the next screen, there's going to be a cat. He's got to get 10 shots into the cat.
You already have chat rooting for you, Richard. What have you done?
I didn't do anything. Mitch put this on himself.
Go mesh!
Yeah, this is such an old speedrun for Mitch. We don't even have a pass, Mitch, to give you an idea how rusty this run is.
That's right. I'm gonna go safe here. I gotta grab this. Also, I'm not doing the slides on these. I don't think so.
Yep, there are single block slides that you can do on those, but it's very dangerous because you can instantly die. And just to point out why Sky said there were different routes in this game, there are two Robot Masters that are weak to Buster. Top Man being one of them, Magnet being the other. And we're gonna see Mitch see how well he does here. Pretty straightforward to kill Top Man. He's invulnerable while he slides across.
Yo, nice, Mitch.
Ooh, I'm sweating already.
Now, is one of the reasons that you maybe didn't continue this is because of the mashing aspect? I know for me, it got pretty intense having
shoulders
to mash.
I had shoulder pains, so I actually had to stop.
That's fair.
Yeah. All right, no death. I was very scared with that last Top Man section. I used one of the tops there to, like, kind of push me or pull me or whatever, right? Onto the ledge. What is it, like a 2-second time save versus a death if it doesn't work?
Alright, so Richard, what does Mitch have to look forward to within this stage?
Well, in this upcoming Proto Man fight, you're gonna need to be mashing a lot to get your shots into Proto Man. And one of the key things is, yeah, if you follow him like that was pretty good mashing, actually, for Mitch. And there's going to be dark rooms in this, so we'll see after a few years if he remembers the layouts of these rooms or not.
Oh my gosh. He needs to do. When you said dark rooms, you weren't kidding, Richard.
Yeah.
Oh, I missed them that one shot.
Yeah, you can definitely tell there's no muscle memory here. I can tell when Mitch plays Mario 3, there's plenty of muscle memory going on, but not with this one.
Yeah,
there's
shout
a
out,
little more.
Shout out to Facet CC, who loves this stage a lot. Actually, funny thing was, I was trying to find Mitch's PB. I looked through 8 years of Mitch's highlights on his Twitch channel. Could not find it. The one video that I saw of Mitch related to Mega Man 3 was him interviewing Facet CC.
Yeah, that's right. I remember that. Okay, what do I do here? I guess I take the death.
Yep, so what you should do here is, yeah, you should just take a death here if you're not comfortable with your top spins, because you could die from that. But
right, I don't want to run out of top spin, because then I have to pretty much learn how to bust through him on the fly.
Which is a very difficult
menuing
fight.
I forgot menuing is such a big thing in this game.
Mm-hmm.
Fortunately for you, menuing is pretty fast in this game. But yeah.
Alright.
Very nicely done.
Now, the premise of Mercy Kill is we're asking speedrunners to run some of their rustiest speedruns to see if they can beat the timer. The thing in the corner is just as a side-by-side comparison, and I believe Richard's PB was fairly near Mitch's PB back in the day.
Yeah, unfortunately, Mitch didn't have a PB VOD.
Yeah, I'm sorry, guys.
It's all good.
So yes, Mitch is not racing past Richard. Mitch is racing that 50-minute estimate, you see. That's what's really going on right now.
But you can see past Richard's doing pretty well. At the end of this first screen in Gemini, which is actually pretty difficult, there is also a skip that you can do by sliding at the end of the screen and then jumping before you get into the cutscene trigger. But this first screen is not trivial. This is definitely one of the harder screens in this game to optimize.
Yeah, I heard this stage is difficult. There's some people in chat who say, yeah, this was not easy. Ooh, extra life.
That extra life is going to be pretty useful, too, since Mitch took an intentional death in that last Robot Master.
Yeah.
Very nice skip from Mitch there.
Mitch remembered how to do a skip from 4 years ago?
Oh, he tried to get another zip at the end of this screen here. Didn't quite get it, but it was good, valiant effort.
Hold on. I'm not climbing ladders. I need my rush coil.
Who doesn't want to see rush?
Yep, one of the things about skipping that is you do get a nice quiet stage here. These giant spitter enemies deal a lot of damage, so we see Mitch waiting on those enemies, which deal just a little bit of damage.
Yeah, I don't want to... I'm not doing it. I remember some slides. I'll do the two tile slides.
Yeah. This is definitely a pretty scary screen. It's very
Mitch
laggy. Lots of enemies on it.
Oh, come on. I short hopped. We got the music back, though.
Is any of this coming back, Mitch? Anything?
A little bit. The struggles I'm having with is not remembering the levels. It's controlling Mega Man. That's what I'm struggling with right now. Getting the right slides and the timing of the jumps and stuff.
You've been playing too much Mario.
I know, it's true. Yeah, nice try, bud. Ah, the leg. No. Okay, I gotta take it really slow. No more sliding. How many lives do I have? Probably one, right? I could probably die one more time. No,
yeah.
I can't. Okay.
Yeah, you can't die.
What is the penalty?
There is a
one-up
down there. You can use Rush Marine. Or you can use Coil.
What is the penalty for game overing in this game, Richard?
Well, you would just need to start the stage over again.
Okay.
Pretty much.
Like, you can continue. But this is the end of the stage, basically. Like, after this screen, there's just a ladder in an enemy.
Yeah, this looks really tough. But those fish look so cute.
No! Come on! I'm getting wrecked! I got the life, though. Do I have Rush Marine?
Yeah, you have Rush Marine.
Easy. What was I thinking?
Yep, with Rush Marine, you can kind of just go across.
Dog submarine, that's so cute!
Get a safety E-tank. Mitch is ready to take on the rest of this game.
You think so?
I'm good now.
Yeah. Got an E-tank. Doesn't need anything.
This is so silly. What am I doing? I was like...
You got two E-tanks now.
Oh, man. That looks so silly. I'm not going to go for the jump. I'll go for the kill here. Okay. What?
Nice.
Up? Yeah. Okay. Alright, Gemini is, for me, the scariest, so I think I'm actually pretty good the rest.
Yeah, the next couple stages are pretty fine. All comes down to how he can do here.
Was this a pretty reset-heavy stage for you, Richard?
That's it. I can't believe he got me.
Mitch was one hit away from beating Gemini, man.
Alright. Alright, now I'm not playing around anymore.
Alright. Yeah, this looks like a pretty tough stage, even if you were to play this for your first time pretty casually.
Yeah, for sure. This is definitely one of the more difficult stages. I think Mitch was banking on not having to use those E-tanks now.
Oh, I think Mitch got an extra life there, I just saw.
He did get a one-up. That's a tease. After the game over, you know, the game just wants to give you a one-up.
Oh, yeah. So for those of you who are here for the first time, this is Mercy Kill Episode 2. Mitch ran SMB 3 Mix and now is running Mega Man 3. So this is the speedrunner with a very, very, very rusty game against the estimate and timer. So if Mitch reaches the 50 minutes and is not finished with the game, that's it. Mitch doesn't get to finish this run. That's the premise of Mercy Kill. So Mitch has given himself this not so generous estimate of 50 minutes to try to clear this game. And it's been 4 years since Mitch has ran this game.
Luckily we have music this time. It's going to be a little bit slower, but you know, you can listen to the wonderful Gemini Man music.
Everything's loading properly too.
That is a good question. What was the world record back when y'all were learning this game?
It was
35 or 36.
Yeah, right? It was probably around that when Mitch was playing. I played like a year later. It was around, yeah, the 34-ish mark, and then Facet CC got a 33. So, yeah, it's around the 33 mark nowadays.
So, Mitch is a runner best known for Mario 3, if you didn't know that already. And as Mitch was talking before, the Mega Man mechanics are just so fundamentally different from the Mario controls. I could, especially after just playing a Mario game, this is probably pretty tough for Mitch to endure.
Yeah, this is actually really hard, but I'm having so much fun. I like the struggle.
This is one of the interesting things. So, you know, we saw Mitch have those struggles going through that stage the first time, but instantly getting through it this time.
Right.
Pretty
it's
fast.
Just that, yeah, knowing like the stupid fireflies and stuff.
Yeah, we were talking about this earlier. Speedrunners get quite rusty at games. I mean, most runners, for the sake of, you know, wanting to grow as speedrunners, usually tackle more than one game. And after a while, they tend to forget what they've learned years and years back. I mean, you remember some tricks, but you're not going to remember every single thing about the game. So one of the goals, ultimately, of Mercy Kill is, yes, it's fun to heckle the runner. Yes, it's good to see runners very rusty at games. However, maybe a speedrunner will decide to re-pick up a game and we could see more discoveries within a game even. It's a way to get games to come back and maybe even grow a bit more. So that's one of the more long-term goals of Mercy Kill.
One of the benefits of the stage that Mitch is going into now, he shouldn't die in this stage because there aren't any pits for him to fall into.
I should have equipped Gemini at the start, right? I forgot.
Yes, you should have. But that's okay.
Are you judging Mitch?
No. I just wanted to give him confirmation with what he said.
Oh, my goodness. This is great. This is still wild to see Mitch running a non-SMB3 game. I'm really getting a lot out of this right now.
This is just Blue Mario. I don't know what you're talking about, Sky.
No pits, he says!
No
pits. Dangerous right
here!
No
pits. You're not gonna die here.
Yeah, we made it.
Oh no, that looked like a pretty dangerous spot, Richard.
There were no dangerous spots.
Oh. Gemini here, right? Yeah. Okay. And then very scary. I
does this ramp up in difficulty quite at the Wily level, uh-oh, Richard?
Hold on.
No, you're
Mitch,
fine.
Mitch got a dual laser there. Laser going around the screen. But gets the kill. That's what matters.
He made a very good jump in my favor there.
But yeah, there are definitely parts in this game that ramp up, but it's definitely not to say that there's, you know, easy platforming at the beginning of the game. There's difficult platforming throughout the entirety of the game.
All right, you're about 15 minutes in so far, Mitch.
All right, I think I can do Spark here because I got needles, and then Spark on thingy, and then thingy on thingy, and yeah.
And the thing and the stuff. So,
I'll take it.
One up is really good.
Yes, it is.
This stage is relatively straightforward. There's going to be some sections where at the end of the stage there will be these platforms here. Where there's like a longer section of them near the end of the stage that he's going to have to watch out for.
That was scary because it's like laggy.
Hey Mitch, I heard you like platforming in this game.
Ooh, I do. Sweating here, I'm sweating.
You look like you're having fun still, though. You don't,
I
you
am.
Don't look too frustrated.
I
you
love
like
Mega
you're...
Man games so much.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Would
oh,
you
I don't
on...
have. That's right. Oh. Magnet for this part, right? It really clears it out.
Yep.
Yep.
Usually in a top first route, Sparkman is done last, but it doesn't lose that much time for you doing it this way. Mitch getting
nice.
Through the end section really nicely.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully he goes in a nice spot. That's not really that nice of a spot. But I'm fine with it. Okay.
Come on, Mitch.
Yeah, pretty easy.
Yay!
Oh, that was... That was really bad RNG, wasn't it?
I'm not 100% sure.
I'm guessing when he was on the left platform, I could have been on the right, but I don't know, I was too scared.
I was gonna say the routes look like they're diverging a little bit as we see Richard right now. Playing through the Sparkman stage.
Yeah, the order for the top first route is after Needle, you do Magnet, Hard, Snake, and Spark.
I'm not gonna go for that one right there, or this one. I'll go for this one, though.
Yep!
There's gonna be another Proto Man section here.
Ah. Come here! Yeah.
What is the small video? Well, Mitch didn't have a VOD because it's been that long since Mitch has touched this game, so that is Richard's run, which was right
which
around Mitch's
3.5 years ago.
Another older VOD.
Jump! Oh, I got a little ahead of myself. Let's do it. Yeah! Dude, that's so hard to get in there. Okay, it's the section.
This is one of the benefits of having Rush Jet for Magnet Stage, is you do not have to go through the Yoku blocks here.
That sucks too, because I know the block section. It's really easy once you get used to it, I know that. Oh, no you don't. Uh-oh. Okay, where's Shuriken? Wait, no, I want SP. There we go.
Beep, 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 beep.
Nice.
Ooh, boss is dodging here.
so much damage on him.
So, Mitch, would you think about running any of the other classic Mega Man games, or is this one the one you absolutely love out of all of them?
I like this one out of all of them the most. I really liked speedrunning Mega Man 9. That game is extremely fun. I think I did more runs of Mega Man 9 than I did of 3, but I really like 3. 3 is just absolutely fantastic game. I have no idea, so I'm going to do the old.
Turn backwards, yep. So, these things at the top, they will spawn bees unless you either kill them or despawn them, like what Mitch is doing.
Yeah,
the alternative
is
to use shadow.
Yeah.
This stage doesn't look like it has a ton of pits in it either.
Yeah, this one's pretty safe.
Kind of reminds me of the layout, at least, and the colors remind me of Woodman from Mega Man 2. That was the only one that I ran out of the Mega Man series. It's been a long time for me, too, even for 2. Mitch is definitely, though, we were talking about this earlier, Richard. Mitch is definitely getting more of a feel for the controls, and he is moving through the stages quicker the more practice he gets with the controls.
Yeah, I think safe for Gemini, I think. I think Mitch is warmed up now.
Oh, yeah.
Ready to get that sub 50.
Yeah, we're currently at 21 minutes right now.
Nah, this one's the most awkward.
Yep, for this proto fight, since he jumps up on these platforms, it's a little bit more difficult to do the mash like you could on the other ones. And there's a health in the next screen, too, and Mitch is going right for it.
Oh, why not?
Yeah, right for it, dude.
You can see when you drop down, if you go right, you're going for the health. If you go left, you're just going.
All right.
Get
no
out
problem
of here,
there
Art
for
man.
Mitch.
Yeah,
more
nice
like Easy Art. Man. That's what they should have named him. Easy Man.
How many Wily stages are there in this one, Richard?
Well, there are 4 dock stages, and then there are, I think, 4 Wily stages after that.
Really?
Yeah. There's.
It's
12.
Been 3.5 years. I can't 100% remember.
It's rusty for everyone.
Yeah, there was a Mega Man 3 tournament on Speed Gaming a few years back, and that was the last that I played of Mega Man 3. 6 Wily stages. Shows how much I remember. Thank you, chat.
So this is a longer game, then. This is way longer than 2, if that's the case.
The stages are pretty short at the end.
Do I use RC here? I can't remember. No, I use
Jet.
Jet. Just go ahead and take that. Easy peasy.
Mitch is not too proud to take the health refills.
Yep, quick thing, interesting thing about those snake enemies, you can just use Jet to get over them like that.
Oh, is it start to... Yeah, it is. Okay.
Mitch is enjoying the music.
The music in this game is very good.
Weep. I gotta go for that scary slide.
Which has now reached a checkpoint. So he can go for whatever scary things he wants to.
Yo, this? Yeah, I'm going for it.
Always.
Such a baby strat. Whatever.
Hey, if it gets you to beat the 50-minute timer, it's not such a bad strat.
I'm going for it right here. I'm not doing any more things.
Yep. And You can see Mitch is jumping off screen here to preserve his rush jet.
Nice.
Mega Man's just gonna jump and shoot at you, so Mega Man's just gonna jump and shoot back.
I turned around. It's so laggy. When they tested this game, they were like, nah, it's fine.
All right. Well, looking like Mitch is going to be about 25 minutes coming out of the Robot Master stages.
Yeah, and the Robot Masters, you know, account for about half the game, so this is going to be a close one.
Ooh.
We'll see.
This may have been the perfect destiny.
The thing about the dock stages, now that you've got all your power-ups, you can kind of go in them whatever order you want to.
The question mark? It was on Gemini's tile? It's like, I wonder.
Oh, does he have to go back through the Gemini stage again?
No, this is a different stage now.
Okay.
Each of the dock stages, you know, it's themed after a specific Robot Master, but the platforms are different, and, like, the whole stages are different.
Why am I doing this better than the first one? Okay, there we go.
Don't speak so soon. You haven't
reached
yet.
Yeah, right? I was doing great, and then I said one thing. Okay, we're in the clear. Oh, beautiful. I remember Needle here for something.
Gonna say this background looks very familiar, but yeah, this is a different type of stage at least. Hopefully there's no huge pits at the end of this like there was in the first Gemini stage.
We have an accomplished Mega Man 3 runner, KLM, in chat right now saying Mitch is on pace right now. He thinks it'll be close, but you could do it.
I'm scared.
Welcome, KLM. Thanks for being here. Did you know Mitch ran this game at one point, KLM? I never knew. I found out that Mitch ran this 2 days ago, and I've known Mitch for a very long time.
Becca! Nah.
It's
I'm a dog.
Nah. This doesn't get old. Russia's submarine's so cute.
Yep, there are some fast strats that you can do with damage boosts in this screen, but you kind of need health for those.
Come on. Give me some health, I'm scared! Wrong one.
You do have some E-tanks.
Ooh, good call. I know I need one for something.
Your lifeline has been used. You're welcome.
That is the only one I will help you with.
Should offer them lifelines on this show from seasoned runners. You only get two or three. That's it.
Ask the chat.
Oh yeah, I would have died for sure.
Yeah, ask the chat, phone a friend.
50-50.
Well, you can either do this or this.
Yeah. Yeah, so Sky Mega Man 2, the Bubble Man.
Yeah, so there's a buffer period, right? That's why I didn't, like, mash my Shadow Man, and that's why I kind of, like, waited, because you can't really just go for it. You just waste all your materials, whatever you want to call them. Powers.
This Dock Needle stage gets very laggy, as we're going to see later on in this stage.
This level's beautiful, you take that back. This level sucks. It's just so laggy.
Yeah,
it
there's...
need to be.
There's quite a bit of lag in the earlier Mega Man games. They got a little bit better as, you know, the team had more time to work on the NES, but...
I almost got it, too.
Yes, we had a question from the chat. Anything that is not Mega Man's basic buster it does have limited ammo on it. This does include the rush jets as well. That's why you can't just constantly spam, you know, this really busted ability, because you only have so much of it.
I think this is the right...
Yep. Yeah, you want to use Spark.
I think, yeah, okay, Airman. Come on, Airman, there's a reason why you were left behind. I'll show you.
I remember facing Airman. This is one of the Robot Masters I've faced off against.
Yep, unfortunately Buster doesn't do that much against this version of Airman. So use Spark instead.
Yeah, and Spark still barely does anything. Oh.
Yeah, I think in my run I went Flash
I'm
then
Air. I'm leaving
that.
God. God, I think I'll be good.
Yep, so Mitch is going to have to avoid the dragonflies, and
ooh,
he should be able to get across this screen.
It's so laggy.
Yep, so one of the reasons, besides avoiding the enemies of jumping off screen, is it does mitigate a little bit of the lag that you experience on the screen.
I thought it was gonna like juke me.
Yeah, Mitch, you're not taking any chances right now.
Oh, baby.
Big health drop.
Oh, nice pickup.
That is something that you want to see.
You just love to see that happen.
If you're rooting for Mitch as opposed to the timer in this match, you want to see big health drops like that.
All right, Mitch, 31 minutes in right now. 19 minutes remain.
Oh, didn't get him. Am I on a snake guy right now?
Oh, this is hard.
Oh, that's right.
Hard knuckle.
Easy peasy. Minutes. We have two shadows, and then Wily stages are fast.
Are they?
Free fights are the longest part.
Yep.
Chat says Mitch is out of lifelines. Yeah, some people do work for the timers, you know? People are used to seeing people meet estimates within speedrun marathons. It's interesting to see a runner actually run up against a timer, especially in a rusty game.
Come on, get me up there.
We got more people rooting for Mitch this time than the timer. Everyone wants to see Mitch beat this 4-year-old game behemoth timer that Mitch has set up here. And it really is. 50 minutes is a really tough timer.
Oh, I think I was supposed to stay Gemini. No, I wasn't. No, this isn't right.
I think
no, I know what it is.
Here.
Yeah.
All right, now that Mitch is done with that, he has reached a checkpoint.
All right, we're going for it.
Oh.
Oh, I tried.
Okay.
No, Mitch, I can't go for it now. I'm not going for it.
Mitch tried for a music despawn there.
Oh.
Basically, you can reduce some lag by stopping the music if you die as you're... Like, if you hit that spike as you're exiting the screen, but Mitch didn't get it, which means he's a little bit safer here.
I don't think I'll die. Okay. Okay, this is snake and E-tank material. I could have done, like, a... I actually should have...
Intentional death instead of an E-tank? Is that
what
you're thinking?
Yeah. It should be okay, as long as I get hit by the boomerangs or whatever they are.
Ooh, is that Quick Pan?
Yes, it is. in these docks.
Ooh, I don't know what I'm supposed to do now. Wait, hold on, I have a trick.
You have a trick? Alright, yeah, let's see it.
I have a lot of lives, too, so that's good.
In the dock stages, they're all Mega Man 2 robot masters that have kind of joined in. I don't know the exact lore. This is actually the final boss of the one-hit KO mod of Mega Man 3. Because there was a mod where if you got hit by anything, you died. And that is the hardest fight.
Alright, so I'm gonna I'll try the sound glitch here. I got three chances. There's one.
So this is the last of the shadow?
Oh, I was so close.
Yes. Ah. This is the last dock stage.
Oh wow, nice match.
Take it safe there.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, come on.
That looked like a really difficult room.
He's not out of the woods just yet. I believe this is Woodman. Woodman's relatively straightforward, but following this mini boss fight, he's gonna be faced with some pits.
Ah, come on, that's really bad. Thank God.
I am intensely focused on this right now. This looks like a really intense run at this point.
It is. The section that he's got to be careful on. Again, we mentioned lag a few times. If he gets a mistimed drop here, that could also spell death for him.
I didn't want to avoid all those.
Mitch proving us all wrong, though.
Extra life.
Hey, what is this? This is top.
Yes, this is top.
I have to take an intentional death. There's no way I'll survive.
Which is fine, because you have
lots of lives.
Yeah, we get Heat Man here. But again, Mitch taking an intentional death.
With the 13 minutes to go, it looks like.
Ooh.
You're gonna be cutting
okay.
Close.
Yeah, Caleb said between when you start the Wily stages and the end, I think it was 10 minutes, according to what we saw. About, give or take. It's gonna be very close. Oh, okay! So we're exiting the last dock stage here. It looks like a 38 flat. Bitch, you got about 2 minutes of elbow room here. That's it.
I know.
I'm not gonna talk as much. I wanna make sure Mitch has enough time to focus here.
Come on, cutscenes in NES games? Come on. We don't got time for these. Look, what is IBN instead of IBM?
I do want to provide, whenever you see the Wily Castle, there's going to be a little bit of flashing, so anyone who's sensitive to that may want to look away when you see the castle for a couple of seconds. Because that's what Mega Man games like to do. They like to show Wily's castle and then a bolt of lightning, so...
What's first boss? I think it's frogs. Frogs, then devil, then... Mega Man.
Alright, we're in the first Wily stage here. Richard, I can't watch. This is probably going to be our tightest finish yet, if there is a finish.
I can't go for it.
No, I would not go for anything that you feel might be super risky unless you feel like you're behind. I'll give you updates if you need them.
Lag so much, didn't register.
You can see just how Rush Jet is one of the most versatile things that you could have in this game to avoid having to do a lot of this difficult platforming.
Oh my gosh. The fry moves so slow for the first one. It's so silly. Oh, it gets fast though.
Even under the clock right now, Mitch is very cheery.
Come on.
There you go. By the way, GG's to past Richard a few minutes ago.
What am I switching to? I don't know what. I have to switch to something right here. I'll remember it. Oh.
I think it was Shadowblade.
I mean, for people who remember the B section, I'll try.
Dr. Wily, being a fan of bees, just put them randomly into the stage, even though the background's kind of just like... assily. As Mitch approaches the Yellow Devil fight, there are a lot of power-ups along the way as well.
Want to make sure you don't fall on the ground there where those spikes are.
What? I was...
Oh no.
I was doinking around.
Doinking around.
I didn't even get a hit. That was so bad.
But she tried to go for a quick kill there where he lined himself up, tried to line himself up in the right position, jump up and mash a bunch of times to get.
I know, I thought I was at least gonna get like one or two. God, this is a big time loss too. Dang it.
Yeah, Chatsan reset. There is no reset in Mercy Kill. This is it.
Close. Hopefully I kill him in this one.
We have a reminder in chat. Remember to doink in moderation.
Oh, come on, game.
I did not realize how elusive this boss can be.
I'm running out of time, guys.
Yeah?
With
yeah,
7 minutes to go.
I don't know if that's possible.
It is.
What's this level?
It is possible.
I know this level.
Alright, there you go. Just keep going, Mitch. Everybody's on the edge of their seats right now in chat. I can see it.
I don't care. Wait, it's a slide.
Taking the top route here.
Oh, there's the slide.
Usually you slide down. Yeah.
Richard's trying to help.
Oh, I would have looked for it regardless. Cause I need the.
I'm just teasing.
I mean, all that health is just appealing anyways.
Oh wow, these rooms, Richard.
We're gonna see Mitch, I think, try to go for a quick kill.
Go, Mitch, go.
Okay. Still got him though.
Right, yeah. So
I think my first bullet registered.
Yeah, I think to.
Alright!
One of the things that you could do in that fight is essentially use that bullet, switch to top, and then that bullet would essentially be, like, the top spin. But Mitch, getting through it, just fine. This is where the biggest chunk of time will be, is after this is going to be the refights. So, how are you feeling, Mitch?
Refights are normally not so bad. I just don't know how long they're going to take me.
You have enough time to finish.
Yeah, Richard is the expert here out of the two of us, so I trust Richard. Oh, here we go. Here's the refights.
I hope this is the Needle Man one. Yes.
All right. Every second counts here.
Come on, jump, 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 jump.
No!
Not there!
No! No!
Why? I was shooting, man. What?
Oh.
I was pressing it. That's all he needed, and I wasted the Gemini, too. So hopefully that's a quick death, though, thankfully.
Yes, yes, that is a quick death.
A Gemini laser is really nice in these refights. It can kill Needle, and Gemini also takes a bunch of damage from Gemini.
Right?
Oh, we're not adding time to this clock. When a time is set, we mean it here.
I don't even remember. Oh, what's this one? Okay, easy. Okay. I did the same thing last time.
Yes, you did.
Asking, what if he's on the last Wily fight? Well, Mitch chose this time for himself.
Mm-hmm. Richard offered. He said, you want 5 more minutes? Nah.
We asked if he wanted to extend this estimate because it is Sky's option to the runners if they would like to, you know, have a lot of time or a little bit of time extra. Unfortunately, this death animation is a little bit long, but it is up to the runner to make these estimates. So if they can't meet it, then it falls squarely on them.
Yep, I'm just the enforcer.
This really does look like it's going to be a photo finish, though.
It really is,
There's
yeah.
There's going to be two more fights after this, so we'll see how both of those go.
That's what makes this show great, though. The photo finishes.
Get out of here. Okay, what's this? Snake Man, I think? Yep.
What a clean Snake Man! That looked good. That looked really good. Alright, what's left, Richard?
So there's two boss fights. One's a boss fight that he's going to use Snake on, and then one's the final boss, which shouldn't take him very long to do. But we'll see how he does on both of them.
Whew.
This boss takes a little bit to get on screen, but he should be able to either use Snake very quickly, but it's very mash intensive, so we'll see how he does.
Oh my gosh, I can't watch. This is too close.
Has like a minute and 48 left. I think he got this.
We'll see.
He can do
we'll
this.
See. Come on, bitch. Oh my gosh.
Boingy, it's fake. What? It's not the real one.
Richard, what's time, by the way?
I'll get time.
All right. I'll have you get time.
Yeah, this is the final boss here. And he should be able to do the thing that he tried to do with the boss a few bosses ago.
Oh my gosh. Come on, let's go!
So, what? Phase one here, he's just gonna use Shadow Blade. He's likely gonna switch to Coil and then try to transfer a bullet to be top, I think. And that is time!
Oh, Mitch!
Yeah!
Minute left under the buzzer, Mitch Flower Power! your GGs out. Oh my gosh.
I did it.
You
60
did it.
60 seconds. Oh, I was so nervous there. This show is awesome, Sky. This was fun.
That was a heck of an estimate there, Mitch. Oh my gosh.
I can't believe that. That was
you
crazy.
Did it.
Almost, like, I even died a couple times, too.
Do yourself a favor and open up chat right now if you don't have it open, Mitch.
Yeah, here, let me open it up.
Yeah, open up chat real quick. You gotta see this. You gotta have to enjoy this moment, alright?
While Mitch is opening up the chat, everyone in chat, open up twitch.tv/MitchPowerPower and tell him that you want to see more Mega Man. Go follow him. Tell him that you want to see more.
Yeah, give me a follow, guys. I think I've earned one follow. Thank you guys so much. Oh, that was so much fun.